Before you take your seat, I want us to praise God one more time.
Kabla uketi ningetaka tumsifu Bwana wakati mmoja.
There are several reasons why we praise God.
Kuna sababu kadhaa kwa nini tunamsifu Bwana.
We praise God as a result of our gratitude to what he has done.
Tunamshukuru kwa sababu ya shukrani ya yale ametutendea.
We have discovered also through this word of the Lord.
Na pia nilimegundua katika neno la Mungu.
That there is a kind of praise you give to God.
Kwamba kuna aina ya sifa tumpayo Mungu.
That you provoke his hand to move in your favor.
Ambayo inamfanya kwamba kuja na kufanyia kazi juu yako.
See, life is very interesting.
There
are what we call battles of life.
Kuna vitu ambazo tunaita vita vya maisha.
And every one of us at some point in time will fight this battle.
Na kila mmoja wetu katika wakati mmoja anapitia hizi vita.
But I've learned from my master Jesus Christ.
Lakini nimesoma kutoka kwa mtangulizi
wangu
Yesu.
Sometimes that things will look rough or insufficient.
Kwa sababu kuna wakati mwingine mambo itaonekana ni dhaifu.
And rather than complain and murmur.
Lakini badala ya kunungunika.
Our Lord Jesus will pick whatever the situation is.
Yesu atachukua hali ilivyo.
And he will give God praise with it.
Na atamshukuru Mungu kwa sababu
what follows after that is provision.
Na abacho kinafuatia baada ya hiyo ni kutwaliwa.
No wonder by revelation the psalmist in Psalm 67 discovered.
Si ajabu kwamba Daudi katika Zaburi 66 aligudua.
And he wrote, he said, let the people praise thee, O God.
Na akasema waacha watu wamsifu Mungu.
He said, let the people praise thee, O God.
Na watu akasema na watu wamsifu Mungu.
And the Lord shall bless his people.
Na kwamba Mungu atawabariki watu wake.
He said, let the people praise you, O God.
Na wana watu wakusifu.
And the earth shall yield its increase.
Na kwamba ulimwengu utatoa mazao yake.
That kind of praise is not a praise of thanksgiving.
Aina ya sifa kama hiyo sio shukrani.
That praise is to provoke the hand of God in your favor.
Sifa kama hiyo ni ya kuchokoza neema za Mungu juu ya maisha.
I don't know where you are right now in your life.
Sijui uko wapi katika maisha yako.
One thing I know is that if you can praise God.
Lakini kitu moja najua kwamba iwapo utamsifu Mungu.
One thing I know is that if you can give God a shout of praise.
Na kama kwamba utatoa sauti kwa Mungu kwa shukrani.
If you can just step out of that situation just for a moment.
Na utoke katika ile hali yako kwa muda tu.
And give God a heartfelt praise.
Na umpatie Mungu sifa kutoka moyoni.
Tonight might just be that night of turnaround for you.
Usiku wa leo ni kwamba mambo itabadilika.
Tonight might just be that night of miracle for you.
Usiku wa leo utakuwa ni usiku wa miujiza kwako.
I came with that expectation.
Nilikuja katika ile hali ya kutarajia.
This weekend beginning from now.
Kwamba weekend hii kuanzia sasa.
Will be a turning point for somebody in this
house. Itakuwa ni haa katika mabadiliko katika maisha ya mtu.
Will be that point where you would know that God has not forgotten you.
Itakuwa ni ile hali hautasahau kwamba Mungu
ako pamoja nawe. That you call it defining moment.
Wakati huo ambao unaita ni wakati wa kiungu.
Beginning from tonight.
Kwa hivyo kuanzia usiku wa leo.
We stir the heart of the master.
Kwamba tukue na moyo kama yule wa mkubwa wetu.
God committed to this next few days.
Na kwamba tukue na moyo wa kujitweka kwa Mungu katika siku hizi.
A 60 second praise.
Na atakupatia sekunde 60 za kusifu.
Give God a 60 second praise.
Kwamba tumpatie Mungu sekunde 60 za sifa.
Praise has no order. He has no order.
Ni kwamba hakuna order yoyote.
It's not that it's not the ones you rehearse. It's the one that comes out of your spirit.
Ni ambayo inatoka
katika roho. 1 2 3 go, let's give him praise.
Skiza.
I have learned in my walk with God.
Kwamba nimesoma kati katika mwendo
wangu na Mungu. Wisdom in your shout.
Kama kuna hekima katika kupasa sauti kwako.
Shouting is not done by nuisance.
Kupasa sauti sio ya kuchokoza.
It was a shout that brought down the wall of Jericho.
Ni sauti ambayo iliporomosha kuta za Jericho.
That's why the scripture says make a joyful noise.
Ndio maandiko inasema tutoe sauti.
If your neighbor does not like shouting.
Kama jirani yako hataki kupasa sauti.
You may want to change your seat tonight.
Wenda ukatamani kuwa muondokee usiku.
But there is wisdom in your shouting.
Lakini kuna hekima katika kushangilia.
Because at some point in time in the scripture.
Wakati mmoja katika maandiko.
The enemies of Israel.
Kwapo maandui wa Israeli.
Overpowered Israel.
Wari wa shida wa Israeli.
When the ark of God was brought into the camp.
Na wakati saduku la agano lililetwa.
And the children of Israel became so excited.
Na wana wa Israeli wakasisimuka.
And they gave God a crazy shout of praise.
Wakamshangilia Mungu.
The Bible says their enemy became afraid.
Biblia inasema maadui wakaogopa.
Because that shout sent a signal to them.
Sababu zile shangwe zilitoa ishara kwao.
That something had come into their midst.
Kwamba kuna kitu kimewajia.
This year I can guarantee you.
Nataka kuhakikishia kwamba
that something has come into your midst.
Kwamba kuna kitu kimekuja miongoni
mwenu. Let us make a signal to the realm of darkness. Let us send a message to the kingdom of darkness. That something great, listen to me.
Nisikize.
Power.
Kwamba uweze.
Changed hand.
Ni kwamba ubadilishe.
On the cross of Calvary.
Katika msalaba
kaifa. In your favor.
Kwa sababu ya kibali chako. Usiku wa leo.
We declare.
Tunatangaza.
That every hand.
Kwamba kila
mkono. That has been conquered from the realm of darkness.
Ambao umetoka.
That has been waging war against you.
Ambao imekuwa ikipiga.
Tonight in the name of Jesus.
Usiku wa leo katika jina la
Yesu. Outstretched hand of the Lord. You didn't hear what I said this year. I said the outstretched hand of the Lord. The hand of our God is not short. The hand of your God, this is not weaker. That hand will be stretched out tonight. I said that hand will wage war for you. That hand will do battle for you. If you believe it, shout amen. Listen to me. Somebody is going completely free tonight. I'm telling you, you are coming out on top. I'm telling you, the Egyptians that have troubled you, tonight will be the last you ever see them. Everything that has made you cry before now, those things that you are tired of, those things that give you headache, I stand tonight by the power and the authority of God. I come to declare to this house that tonight is the night of liberty. Tonight is the night of liberation. The word of God says, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. There is freedom to dance. I said there is freedom to travel. Listen to me. Whatever has restricted your liberty. Whatever has restricted you. Every opposition against your progress. Tonight in the name of Jesus. Through the Spirit of God. You are free in Jesus' name. If you believe in DC. Put your hands together for the Lord. And give Him a praise. We have made a statement tonight.
Ni kwamba tumetangaza tangaza usiku wa leo.
And the kingdom of darkness know it.
Na kwamba ufalme wa giza wafahamu.
We will begin to work out everything that God has set aside for us for this weekend.
Kwamba tukiondoka kila kitu Mungu ametutengea wiki hii.
I have lived with this truth for nearly over 15 years now.
Na nimeishi na haki hii katika miaka yangu
15.
Ni kwamba Mungu ni mtumikia.
The God that you serve.
Mungu mtumikiao.
It's not a God of a better yesterday.
Yes, si Mungu ati wa ubora wa jana.
We belong to an ever progressive family.
Sisi ni wa familia ya muondoko wa kufanikiwa kila wakati.
The increase and of the peace of his kingdom.
Ni kwamba katika amani ya ufalme wake.
Scripture says there shall be no end.
inasema halitakuwa na mwisho.
We are admonished in 2 Corinthians 3:18.
Wakorintho wa 3:18 tuambiwa.
We fix our gaze on Jesus through the word.
Kwamba unapomtangaza kumwangazia Yesu katika neno lake.
It says we are transformed.
Ni kwamba sisi tutabadilishwa.
What's the word now? Metamorphosized.
Ni kwamba sisi tumepata kubadilishwa
into the same very image of our Lord Jesus.
Kufanana na yeye kama.
And when that happens, guess what?
Na nini kinatendeka baada
hapo? Progress kicks in.
Ni kwamba uzuri
kwamba unaingia ndani. We go from glory to glory.
Ni kwamba tunaondoka katika utukufu
kwa utukufu. Are you ready to enter into another realm in God?
Je, uko tayari kuondoka katika mwondoko mwingine?
Put your hands together and sit down.
Weka mikono yako pamoja na uketi chini.
Majestically. Thank you. Thank you, beautiful choir.
Asante, asante.
You helped me greatly.
Asante, umenisaidia vizuri.
I know many of you are here to receive a word from the Lord.
Najua wengi tuko hapa kupokea neno kutoka kwa Mungu.
But would you allow me first of all appreciate the bishop of this house?
Lakini niruhusu kwamba nimtambue askofu wa nyumba hii.
And the first lady of this house.
Na first lady wa kanisa hili.
Sir and ma, I want to say thank you.
Nataka kusema ni asante sana.
For receiving me in your heart first of all.
Kunipokea katika moyo wenu kwanza.
And then receiving me in this beautiful ministry.
Na pia kunikaribisha katika huduma hii nzuri sana.
I discovered online.
Nilitambua kwamba
that this church is 38 years old, am I right?
Kwa bahiri kanisa ni la miaka 38.
36. That is a lot of years of labor.
Hiyo ni miaka mingi sana.
Not only have we counted the blessings of God.
Sio tu tumekutana na baraka za Mungu.
But I can assure you many scars have come with those years.
Lakini kuambia kwamba kuna vikofu vingi ambazo tumezipitia.
When I first got married to my wife 15 years ago.
Wakati nilipata kumuoa bibi yangu miaka 15 ipitayo.
I was so fascinated about her beauty.
Kwamba mimi nilikuwa navutiwa sana na urembo wake.
And I will always celebrate that even up to now.
Na pia huwa nasherehekea lile mpaka sasa.
But I found myself appreciating her birth scars more than her beauty.
Na nimekuwa nikiangalia zile kofu zake sana kuliko urembo wake.
I've gone through labor room with her 3 times.
Nimeenda katika chumba cha kujifungua na yeye mara 3.
And witnessed firsthand what she had to go through to bring forth our 3 beautiful children.
Na nikashuhudia ni nini alipitia kabla awalete duniani watoto wetu warembo.
That day, those stretch marks mean more than stretch marks to me.
Kwa hivyo zile alama zinamaanisha sana kwangu.
And that is what I praise the more.
Na hiyo ndio kuwa nafurahia hata sana.
So while I thank God for the victories of this house.
Ninapomshukuru Mungu kwa ushindi wa jumba hili.
I want to take time to celebrate your scars.
Nataka nichukue nafasi kusherehekea zile kofu.
Because without them we won't see all of this.
Kwa hivyo bila hayo hatungeweza kuona haya yote.
Scars are proof of someone willing to pay the price.
Hii kofu ni ishara za mtu ambaye analipa gharama.
So may I indulge you tonight to help me celebrate these 2 generals.
Kwa hivyo niwaombe mnisaidie kuwafurahia hao wawili.
Let me leave a secret with you.
Wacha niwaambie hivi.
Whatever you appreciate,
kila wakati unaposhukuru
appreciates more in your life.
Ni kwamba unapanda juu katika maisha yako.
So live a life of appreciation.
Kwa hivyo ishi maisha ya kushukuru.
And you will see how your life will appreciate.
Na utaona vile maisha yako itanawili.
So I want to thank you son my once again.
Kwa hivyo nataka kuwashukuru mara tena.
Also this day would not have been possible.
Kwa hivyo pia siku hii haingewezekana
without the love
pasipo upendo
of Bishop John and Pastor Patricia.
Kwa ya upendo wa Bishop John na Pastor Patricia.
Whom you know and love very well.
Kwamba ninawapenda sana mjua.
They have been the conduits where of this connection between I and Bishop and his wife.
Wamekuwa katika ile hali ya kuunganisha sisi na askofu.
Not only that but the fact that I am in Kenya for the first time in my life.
Na sio hiyo tu ni kwamba pia niko katika nchi ya Kenya kwa mara yangu ya kwanza.
I owe it to this general of faith as well.
Kwa sababu hawa general wa vita.
Thank you for the honor.
Asante sana kwa ile
heshima. I celebrate all the hard working leaders and pastors and everyone in this house.
Nasherekea wachungaji wote na viongozi ambao wanafanya kazi kwa bidii kanisani.
Without you, I'm sure Bishop and Mama would not be here today.
Bila nyinyi najua askofu na mama hawangekuwa hapa wakati huu.
So I celebrate you all in Jesus' name.
Kwa hivyo nawashukuru sana pia.
In Jesus' name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
And in advance help me appreciate this wonderful man of God.
Na pia ndumshukuru huyu mtu wa Mungu.
That is going to allow my voice to be heard in the right way.
Abaataruhusu usemi wangu upatikane kwa njia mwafaka.
Amen.
Amina.
All right, I have a word in my spirit.
And I'm
going to try and get as much of it out as possible.
But the
good thing is that we have several days to do this. So we will take it as what, as though you are roasting meat.
Kutaichukua ni kama tunafanya nyama choma.
Slow and steady.
Ni kwamba inaenda pole pole lakini kwa uhakika.
Somehow we will arrive there on Sunday.
Na tuone venye tutafikia pale siku ya Jumapili.
Glorious arrival.
Na itakuwa na utukufu sana.
In Jesus' name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Would you turn your Bible with me to Luke chapter 4?
Ungefungua nami katika kitabu cha Luka 4.
It will be a bit of a read.
Katika kitabu cha Luka 4.
But it is necessary for what I believe God wants me to share with you tonight.
Lakini ni vizuri kwa vile naona Mungu ananiruhusu tushiriki nanyi usiku huu.
So Luke chapter 4 verse 1.
Luka 4 mstari wa kwanza.
He said then Jesus being filled with the Holy Spirit.
Inasema Yesu alipojazwa na Roho Mtakatifu.
Returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness.
Akarejea kutoka Yordani akiongozwa na Roho Mtakatifu nyikani.
Being tempted for 40 days by the devil.
Kijaribiwa kwa siku 40 na yule muovu.
And in those days he ate nothing.
Na kwa zile siku hakula chochote.
And afterwards when he had ended he was hungry.
Na wakati alimalizia alikuwa na njaa.
And the devil said to him.
Na yule muovu akamwambia.
If you are the son of God.
Iwapo wewe ni mwana wa Mungu.
Command these stones to become bread.
Toa amri kwa haya mawe na ifanyike mkate.
But Jesus answered him saying.
Na Yesu akamjibu kwa kusema.
It is written man shall not live by bread alone.
Imenakiriwa kwamba mwanadamu hataishi kwa mkate peke yake.
But by every word but it proceeds out of the word of God.
Ila kwa neno lolote litakao katika kinywa cha Mungu.
Then the devil taking him up a high mountain.
Na yule muovu akampelekea katika mlima pa juu.
Showed him all the kingdom of the world in a moment.
Na akamuonyesha ulimwengu wote kwa wakati mmoja.
And the devil said to him, all this authority I'll give to you.
Na yule muovu akamwambia amri hii yote nitakupa juu yako.
And the glory for this has been delivered to me.
Na utukufu wa haya umeachiliwa kwa mikono yangu.
And I give it to whomever I wish.
Na kwamba nitampa yeyote nitakaye.
Therefore you will worship before me.
Kwa hivyo utaniabudu mbele zangu.
All will be yours.
Na haya yote yatakuwa yako.
And Jesus answered and said to him.
Na Yesu akamjibu na kumwambia.
Get behind me Satan.
Ondoka nyumba yangu mbele yangu
Shetani. For it is written.
Kwa sababu imenakirika.
You shall worship the Lord your God.
Kwamba utamwabudu Mungu wako.
And him alone you shall serve.
Na yeye peke yake ndiye utamtumikia.
Then he brought him to Jerusalem.
Na kisha akamleta Yerusalemu.
Set him on the pinnacle of the temple.
Na akamweka katika kilele cha
hekalu. And said to him.
Na akamwambia.
If you are the son of God.
Iwapo wewe ni mwana wa Mungu.
Throw yourself down from here.
Jitupe chini kutoka mahali hapa.
For it is written.
Maana imenakiriwa.
He shall give his angel charge over you.
Kwamba atawatoa malaika wake juu yako.
To keep you.
Na ili wakuhifadhi.
And in their hands.
Na kwa mikono yao.
They shall bear you up.
Ni kwamba watakuinua.
Lest you dash your foot against the stone.
Kama siva usijikoe mguu wako katika jiwe.
And Jesus answered him.
Na Yesu akamjibu.
And said to him.
Na akamwambia.
It has been said.
Na kwamba imeandikwa.
You shall not tempt the Lord your God.
Usimjaribu Mungu wako.
Now when the devil had ended his temptation.
Na wakati shetani alikuwa amemaliza majaribio zake.
He departed from him until an opportune time.
Akamuondokea kwa ule wakati.
Tonight the enemy will depart from his torment against you.
Usiku leo shetani atakuondokea.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Shout amen to that.
Sema amina.
Then verse 14.
Aya yake ya 14.
Then Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit.
Na Yesu akarejea kwa roho kwa nguvu za Roho Mtakatifu.
Then Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit.
Na Yesu akarejea kwa nguvu za Roho Mtakatifu.
To Galilee.
Pale Galilaya.
And news of him went out throughout the surrounding regions.
Na jumbe kumhusu zikaenea pote.
And he taught in their synagogues.
Na akafunza katika sinagogi zao.
Being glorified by all.
Akitukuzwa na wote.
May the Lord bless the reading of his word.
Na Bwana abariki somo lake.
In Jesus name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Tonight I want to quickly speak to you.
Usiku leo nataka kwa upesi nikunenee.
On the subject.
Kwa kichwa cha ujumbe.
From wilderness to blessedness.
Kutoka katika nyika kwenda katika baraka.
From wilderness to blessedness.
Kutoka nyikani hadi ya baraka.
It is my prayer that as I preach the word of God tonight, that your spirit man will be revived. And that you will be able to go on and lay hold of that which God has for you in this season. If that is your expectation, say amen with me. The first thing I want to say here tonight is that the faith life and the faith work which we live, despite the glorious destiny it holds for you and I, it is one that will come with seasons of life. In other words, for us to navigate our way
kwa jambo lingine, iwapo tutaweza kupata kuondoka jiani,
through the promises of God
katika zile ahadi za Mungu,
and arrive at the glorious destiny God has for you and I,
na tufikie katika upeo wa utukufu Mungu ametutwalia,
this walk will take us through different seasons in life.
Ulimwengu huu utatupitiza katika za mtofauti maishani.
God's promises,
ahadi za Bwana,
prophecies,
na nabii zake,
and God's purposes,
na katika kusudi zake,
are carried out through time,
waba zimebebwa katika wakati,
seasons,
na katika zamu,
dispensations,
na katika hali ya miodoko,
and generations,
na katika vizazi.
There is nothing God,
hakuna kitu chochote Mungu,
will accomplish in our life,
akwaba atadhibitisha katika maisha yetu,
that he will accomplish through this formula,
ambao haitapitia katika hali hizi.
Therefore it is important we know,
kwa hivyo ni muhimu sana tufahamu,
that no season is better than the other,
kwamba hakuna zamu ambao ni jema kuliko ingine.
Each seasons of life has its own purpose.
Zamu yoyote ya maisha ina kusudi.
In some part of the world,
katika sehemu zingine za ulimwengu,
for almost 15 years I lived in Britain,
kwa miaka 15 ambao nimeishi pale Uingereza,
and in England we go through 4 seasons,
na pale Uingereza huwa tunapatia pitia katika hali nne za
mwaka.
Na nimesikia watu wakisema,
I prefer spring from autumn,
ni kwamba mtu anatamani spring kuliko ile hali ya autumn.
Most people will prefer summer from winter,
na wengine watafurahia hali ya hali kuliko hali ya baridi.
But if you study climate,
lakini ukiangalia hali za anga,
you realize that all 4 seasons,
utaona zile za mzote nne,
are essential to the cycle of life,
ni za muhimu sana katika maisha.
Without autumn there are things that will suffer,
bila ile autumn kuna vitu ambazo zitaangamia.
Without summer there are things that will suffer,
ama hali ya bila hali ya joto kuna vitu zingine zitaangamia.
Without winter there are things that will suffer in that part of the world,
bila hali ya baridi kuna vitu zitaangamia sehemu zingine ulimwenguni.
Every season has its place,
kila zamu ina kusudi na sehemu yake.
Seasons is what gives us assurance and confidence in seed time and harvest time,
zile zamu ndizo zinapatia uhakikisho wa Mungu katika wakati wa kupanda na wakati wa kuvuna.
Because without season,
kwa sababu bila zile zamu,
there is no guarantee of seed time, hakuna, and harvest time,
hakuna uhakikisho wa wakati wa kupanda na kuvuna.
So seasons are very important,
kwa hivyo zile hali ni za muhimu sana.
Seasons are like pregnancy trimesters,
zile zamu ni kama ile hali ya kubeba mimba.
When a woman conceives a fetus in her womb,
wakati mwanamke anapata ile mimba katika tumbo lake,
she goes through seasons that are like trimesters,
anapitia zile zamu tatu za maisha ya ile hali.
And for most ladies in the beginning it is very uncomfortable,
na kwa kina dada wengine pale mwanzo inakuanga si ya kuridhisha.
Because they throw up and they become sick,
kwa sababu wakati mwingine anapata kugojeka.
Uncomfortable changes happen during those trimesters,
na kutakuwa na mabadiliko ambayo si ya kuridhisha katika zile zamu.
In the beginning you see nothing happening physically,
na wakati wale wa mwanzo hautaona vitu zinabadilika kwa kuonekana.
But that does not mean that something is not happening,
lakini
hiyo
haimaanishi kwamba hakuna kitu kinaendelea pale ndani.
So a woman has to submit through those seasons,
kwa hivyo mwanamke lazima atapitia zile zamu,
to arrive at a joyful blessing,
na ili fikie katika hali yake ya furaha iliyo inamtangulia.
And even tonight if you are believing God for a seed in your womb,
kwa hivyo hata siku ile na muamini Mungu kwa sababu ya begu tumboni mwako,
you are in the right place tonight,
ni kwamba uko katika hali inayofaa.
Because God will answer your prayer tonight,
kwa sababu Mungu atajibu ombi lako usiku
leo, in the name of Jesus,
katika jina la Yesu.
In other words,
kwa maneno mengine,
just as this trimester leads to delivery,
kama vile zile za mtatu za kina dada zinapelekea kupata mtoto,
so are the seasons of life leading us to destiny.
Hivyo ndivyo zamu za maisha zinatupelekea upeo.
The Bible says in Psalm 30 verse 5,
Biblia inasema Zaburi 34 mstari wa 5,
for his anger is but for a moment,
kwa sababu ile hasira yake tu ni kwa muda,
his favor is for life,
na kibali chake ni kwa maisha utele,
weeping may endure for the night,
ukilio chaja usiku,
but joy comes in the morning,
lakini furaha yatuajia asubuhi.
In other words, there is a season that may look like a dry season,
kwa hivyo kuna zamu inaweza onekana ni kama ya ukame,
a season where all manners of things that you don't like happening to you,
wakati mambo ambayo hauyapendi yanakutendekea.
But the Bible says that the season does not last forever,
lakini Biblia inasema ile hali si ya kudumu.
It says weeping may endure for the night,
ni kwamba kilio chaja usiku,
but joy comes in the morning,
lakini furaha yaja asubuhi.
And so we see this process in the life of our master Jesus Christ.
Tunaona hili hali katika maisha ya Yesu Bwana wetu.
As we have read in Luke chapter 4.
Kama vile tumesoma Luka 4.
Now let us back up a little bit.
Wacha turudi nyuma kidogo.
In Luke chapter 3 verse 20.
Luka 3:20.
Here was a glorious moment for Jesus.
Ilikuwa ni wakati wa utukufu sana kwa Yesu.
It was that moment he had waited for all his life.
Ilikuwa ni ile nafasi alikuwa amesubiria maishani mwake.
At the moment where John the Baptist would baptize him. Luke 3:21.
Luka 3:20.
Yeah, and when all the people will be, when Jesus will be baptized.
Na wakati Yesu alienda kubatizwa.
And we read in this passage of the scripture.
Nitasoma katika kifungu hichi cha.
John the Baptist had baptized Jesus.
Wakati Yohana alimbatiza Yesu.
Not only was he baptized, church.
Si tu kubatizwa tu alibatizwa.
There was a voice from heaven.
Lakini kulikuwa na sauti kutoka mbinguni.
The scripture says.
Biblia inasema.
That the spirit of the Lord.
Kwamba roho wa Mungu.
In form of a dove.
Akwa aisha.
Descended and rested on him.
Akateremka na akatoa katika kichwa chake.
And the word of the Lord went forth.
Na neno la Bwana likatokea.
An affirmation went forth.
Na hakikisho likatolewa.
Today what we call in Christendom an ordination.
Kwa siku hizi ambazo tunaita ni kama ordination.
A commissioning.
Ama kutuolewa kwenda katika huduma.
Public affirmation of the call of God on someone.
Ni hakikisho la mwito wa Mungu juu ya mtu ya maisha ya mtu.
He has been called unto greater works.
Kwamba ameitwa kwa sababu ya kazi.
And so all of this happened.
Kwa hivyo hili lilitendeka.
But in my thinking,
lakini katika tafakari zangu,
as a human being,
kama mwanadamu,
I would have thought,
ningefikiria,
that Jesus would leave that epic moment.
Kwamba Yesu angetoka katika wakati huo,
and went on into doing great things.
Na hadi akafanya mambo makuu.
Church, it's like the December 31st night.
Ni kama tarehe 31 Desemba.
The crossover night.
Wakati tunamkesha wa kuvuka mwaka.
Where every one of us is waiting for that prophetic word.
Ambapo kila mtu anagojea hilo neno.
To usher us into a new season.
Ambapo ndatupelekea katika za mpya.
To usher us into a new year.
Kutupelekea katika mwaka mpya.
And that we receive the word.
Na ili tupokee hapo neno.
2020.
Kwamba mwaka wa 2020.
Year of restoration and manifestation.
Mwaka wa urejesho na udhihirisho.
And we excited and eagerly receive the word.
Kwamba tulipokea neno kwa msisimuko.
And we enter into the new year.
Na tunaingia katika mwaka mpya.
And suddenly a shocker.
Na kwa puda si puda tunapata
jambo. It's almost like we're going in reverse.
Ilikuwa ni kama tunarudi nyuma.
And you begin to wonder.
Na unaanza kujiuliza.
I just received a prophetic word.
Nimepokea tu neno la kinabii.
How come nothing is happening?
Je, iwaje kwamba hakuna kitu kinatendeka?
Why do I have to go into this situation? Why do I have to go into this?
Kwa nini nipitie katika hali hii?
Right after I have received the prophetic word.
Baada tu ya kupokea neno la kinabii.
But may I encourage you tonight.
Lakini kutia moyo usiku huu.
That you are not alone.
Kwamba hauko peke yako.
Jesus received the prophetic word.
Kwamba Yesu alipokea neno la kinabii.
The spirit of the Lord came on him.
Na Roho Mtakatifu akamjia.
And here we are told.
Na hapa tunaambiwa.
He rose up from that place.
Ni kwamba aliondoka katika wakati huo.
And then ended up in the wilderness.
Na akaingia katika hali ya nyika.
Wilderness spiritual.
Kapara katika nyika kiroho
represent seasons.
Ni katika ile zamu.
And usually,
na kwa sana sana,
it takes on the same nature as a physical wilderness.
Inachukulia hali kama ile ya nyika ionekanayo.
It takes on that same nature of lonesomeness.
Ni kama ile hali ya upweke.
It takes on the nature of dryness.
Ni kama hali ya ukame.
Where Where it seems like nothing is happening in your life.
Inaonekana kuna kitu kitendekacho.
Where it seems like you have not received a word from God.
Inaonekana ni kama hujapokea neno kutoka kwa Mungu.
Jesus went from that place.
Na Yesu alitoka akaenda katika hali
ile. And ended up in the wilderness.
Na akaingia katika nyika.
And so sometimes in life,
kwa hivyo wakati mwingine maisha,
you and I begin to wonder.
Unaanza kujiuliza.
Why is all of this happening to me?
Kwa nini haya yote yananitendekea?
Why am I going through this?
Je, nipiti kwa nini nipitia haya?
Because I have a word on my life.
Lakini kwa na neno
Pastor has declared a word on me.
Ni kwamba pastor kanena neno juu
yangu. I have been anointed to prosper.
Kwamba nimewekwa mafuta na ili nawili.
And all this is going on in my life.
Mafuta tu haya yote yanatendeka maisha
yangu. It looks like the enemy has an upper hand.
Na inaonekana ni kama shetani ana shida.
I'm here to tell you tonight.
Lakini niko hapa kwa bii usiku wa leo.
If Jesus went through his seasons.
Kama Yesu alipitia zile zamu.
Whether as an individual.
Kama wewe mtu binafsi.
Either as a church.
Ama katika kanisa.
Or as a family.
Ama kama jamii.
A business owner,
ama katika biashara,
or as an employee,
ama kama
or a career person,
ama mtu mwingine,
or a minister of God,
ama mtumishi wa Mungu,
we will all go through
tutapitia
some sort of seasons in our lives,
hali zingine maishani,
that will take on the nature of the wilderness.
Ambazo zitachukulia hali ya upweke wa nyika.
It will look like the enemy has gained upper hand over your life.
Kama shetani amekushinda.
It seems like everything you have prayed and fasted for,
inaonekana kama kitu chote ulichoombea na
kufunga, or you have prayed and fasted against,
na umeomba na kufunga tena,
they're all coming back at you.
Zote zinakurejelea.
It's like one step forward and two step backwards.
Ni kama hatua moja mbele na mbili nyuma.
It's like all the things that you thought you had buried in your past.
Ni kama zile vitu ulifikiria umezika katika maisha.
And suddenly they begin to raise their ugly heads at you again.
Zinaanza kukuinukia mara tena.
However, I have come to encourage you tonight.
Lakini hali na yote nimekuja kukuambia.
That your wilderness season.
Katika hali yako ya nyika.
Are not orchestrated by the devil.
Ni kwamba hazijaletwa na shetani.
The devil is not the one in control of the season.
Sio shetani ambaye anaziongoza hizi zamu.
The devil is not the one involved in what you are going through.
Sio shetani anahusika mjambo unalopitia.
Sometimes we give too much power to the devil.
Wakati mwingine tunampa shetani nguvu nyingi.
How do I know this?
Bwana nijue haya.
I know this because the Bible says.
Najua haya kwa sababu neno la Mungu.
Chapter 4 verse 1.
Katika Luka 4:1.
Jesus been filled with the Spirit.
Kwa Yesu baada kujazwa na Roho.
Led into the wilderness
katika hali ya nyika.
So it was the Lord that led him into the wilderness.
Kwa hivyo ni Yesu ama ni Bwana alimuelekeza pale.
Because it must have been essential for his destiny.
Kwa sababu ilikuwa ni hali yake kupitia katika upeo.
Number 2, how do I know it's not the devil?
Namba ya pili, kwa nini nijue sio shetani?
The Bible says in verse 14.
Biblia inasema aya 14.
He returned in the power of the Spirit.
Kwa aliporejea kwa nguvu za Roho Mtakatifu.
Listen to me if you have ever been attacked by the devil before.
Nisikize kama iwapo umesha na shetani.
Ah, you would know that the enemy comes to kill completely.
Na utajua kwamba shetani huja kuangamiza kabisa.
I have never heard the enemy promoting anybody.
Sijaisikia shetani akimpandisha cheo yoyote.
I have never seen the enemy release people.
Na sijaiona shetani akiwaachilia watu.
His mission is to terminate completely.
Huduma yake ni kuangamiza kabisa.
But here we are told.
Lakini hapa tuambiwa kwamba
Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit.
Ni kwamba Yesu alirejea kwa nguvu za Roho Mtakatifu.
In other words, Jesus went from the wilderness.
Kwa maana neno mengine kwamba Yesu akaenda nyikani.
And he went to a state of blessedness.
Na kaenda katika hali ya ubarikiwa.
So I have come to encourage you tonight.
Nimekuja kutia moyo usiku
wa leo. Whatever you think you may be going through.
Kwamba hapa unafikiria unapitia.
Don't give the credit to the devil.
Usimpatie shetani ile sifa.
God is working something in your favor.
Yesu ama Bwana anatenda kazi juu yako.
The wilderness is a necessary part to destiny.
Ile nyika ni hali muhimu kwa upeo wako.
Many years ago when I gave my life to Christ.
Miaka mingi iliyopita nilipookoka.
I came across an important document.
Nilikuja nikapitana na stakabadhi muhimu sana.
Changed my mentality.
Ambayo ilibadilisha hali yangu ya fikra.
And it was a document on the Bible software called Eastward.
Na ilikuwa ni kuhusu Eastward.
Just like many Bible apps we have today.
Kama vile tunazo apps mingi kwa simu za Biblia.
But Eastward was one of the first Bible apps you would get back then.
Lakini ile application ilikuwa ya kwanza ambayo tungeipata zile siku.
One day I was going through Eastward.
Na nilikuwa napitia ile application.
I discovered it had extra resources for my personal study.
Na nikajua kwamba ilikuwa na vitu zingine ambazo ningetumia kwa kusoma.
Including maps from the Bible.
Baadhi ya hizo ilikuwa ni ramani za Biblia.
And so these maps graphically showed us most of the journeys we read about in the Bible but never saw how they traveled.
Na hizi ramani zote zilikuwa zinaonekana ile miondoko ama safari zilizoendwa katika Biblia.
And what you're wondering, what did I discover?
Na nini ambao niligundua?
I found the map of Israel's journey from Egypt to the promised land.
Nikaona ramani ya safari kutoka pale Misri mpaka Israel.
And its surrounding environment.
Na vitu ambazo zilikuwa zimezunguka pale.
And I discovered this truth.
Na nikagundua ukweli huu.
There was not an alternative way.
Kwamba hakukuwa na njia mbadala.
There was no other route.
Hakukuwa na njia nyingine mbadala.
That the children of Israel.
Ambao wana wa Israeli.
Can travel through to arrive at their promised land.
Ambao wangeipitia wafike mahali walikuwa wameambiwa watafika.
They had to go through the wilderness.
Lazima wangepitia pale nyikani.
There was no other way.
Hakukuwa na njia nyingine.
And that day the Holy Spirit said something to me.
Na hiyo siku Roho wa Mungu akaniambia kitu.
If I'm ever going to do anything significant in your life.
Kama nitafanya kitu chochote cha maana maishani mwako.
Prepare for the seasons of life.
Ni kwamba ujiandae katika zile zamu za maisha.
Learn how to navigate through the seasons of your life.
Na ujue vile utaondoka katika zile zamu za maisha.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Wacha niwaambie mabibi na mabwana.
DC.
Ni kwamba watu wa kanisa hili.
Christianity is not a challenge free path.
Ni kwamba hii journey hii safari si rahisi.
I know we like to come to church.
Najua tunapenda sana kuja hapa kanisani.
I look good in all of this.
Na naonekana vizuri kwa haya.
And the moment we have an idea somebody is going through some things.
Na wakati tunajua mtu anapitia kitu.
We begin to judge them.
Tunaanza kuwahukumu.
We think they don't have the Holy Ghost anymore.
Tunafikiria ni kwamba hana Roho Mtakatifu tena.
How can he be praying in tongues?
Itachukuaje anaomba kwa dimi?
And yet he is going through this.
Na anapitia haya.
Sometimes we even beat ourselves down.
Wakati mwingine tunajiagusha chini.
How can I be tithing and yet I'm going through this?
Na unasema bwana natoa fungu la 10 na
listen
haya.
To me.
Nisikize.
Jesus said,
Yesu alisema,
in this world,
katika ulimwengu huu,
we will go through some stuff.
Utapitia mambo.
But we can be assured,
lakini tuhakikishiwa,
that we will come through,
kwamba tutashinda,
because he has overcome this world for us.
Kwa sababu Yesu alishinda ulimwengu kwetu.
By revelation, David said,
kwa ufunuo Yohana akasema,
even though I walk through,
kama ukipitia,
you are only walking through.
Ni kwamba unapita tu.
I said you are only walking through.
Ni kwamba unapita.
You are not going to get stuck.
Hakwamba hautaenda kukwama.
Life is a passage.
Kwamba maisha ni hali ya kuondoka.
And the passage has seasons in them.
Na katika ule mwondoko una zamu zake.
Do not think the Lord is not with you.
Na kuna kitu ambacho Mungu ameandaa.
Do not think that you have done something wrong.
Na usifikirie umetenda kitu kibaya.
In fact, if you have a valid promise on your life.
Ni kwamba una hakikisho la dhamana maishani mwako.
Get ready for seasons of life.
Jipange na ili upitie zamu za maisha.
The word of the Lord.
Kwa neno la Mungu.
Prophecies are like babies.
Ni kwamba nabii zile nabii ni kama watoto.
Seasons and times.
Ni kwamba hali ya maisha na zamu.
Dispensations and generations.
Na vizazi vizazi.
They are like wombs that carry the baby.
Wani kama zile mimba ambazo zinabeba mtoto.
The baby must go through the womb.
Lazima mtoto atapita katika ile tumbo.
Prophecies must go through seasons.
Na zile nabii lazima zipitie zile zamu.
Promises must go through times.
Ahadi lazima zipitie wakati.
And they will be uncomfortable sometimes.
Na wakati mwingine zitakuwa si za kuridhisha.
But you don't give up, you keep going.
Lakini usikata tamaa.
You keep holding on to what God has called you to do.
Usidi kushikilia ambacho Mungu amesema.
Can I quickly encourage somebody tonight?
Nitie mtu moyo usiku wa leo.
See, don't let the enemy put a blame guilt trip on you.
Na usiache shetani akuwekelea lawama.
The Bible says.
Biblia yasema.
When the sower sowed the word.
Na wakati wa mpanzi aliana neno.
And there were ones that were attacked by the enemy.
Na kuna watu ambao walishambuliwa na maadui. Biblia inasema.
That persecution arose because of the word.
Na kwamba kuadhiriwa kwa kanisa kukaondoka kwa sababu ile neno.
In other words.
Kwa maneno mengine.
The validation.
Ni kwamba kuhakikishiwa.
There is something that is of the Lord.
Abara tunabeba kitu ambacho ni kutoka kwa Mungu.
The enemy may show up.
Ni kwamba shetani ama adui anaweza onekana.
Most importantly,
lakini za muhimu ni kwamba
seasons are the next thing you face.
Ni kwamba zamu ni kitu kile kingine utakubana nacho.
The moment you receive a word,
kwa wakati unapokea neno,
get ready for a season.
Jiandae kwa sababu ya zile zamu.
It is not because of your behavior.
Si kwa sababu ya tabia zako.
It is not because of the wrong thing you have done.
Wala si kwa sababu ya kutotenda mambo.
It is not because of the past mistakes.
Ama si kwa sababu ya makosa uliyotenda.
The scripture simply says.
Biblia inasema.
That persecution.
Ni kwamba kuadhiriwa kwa kanisa.
Arose because of the word, not you.
Ilionuka ni kwa sababu ya lile neno.
It is because of the things you have received from God.
Ni kwa sababu ya mambo unayopokea
kutoka kwa Mungu. Because of the greatness of God's purpose for your life.
Ni kwa sababu ya ukuu wa mwito wa Mungu juu ya maisha yako.
That's what makes the enemy to show up.
Hiyo ndio inaonekana ama inasababisha shetani kuonekana.
These are two indications.
Na haya ni ishara mbili.
That the devil does not have the upper end.
Ni kwamba shetani hana ushindi.
These are two indications.
Ni kwamba hili ni hakikisho la kweli.
What you are going through.
Ambacho unakipitia.
It's not the enemy.
Ni kwamba si adui.
You are going through a season in life.
Unapitia tu zamu katika
and
maisha.
Those seasons, even though we don't like them.
Na chua zile zamu hata kama hatuzipendi.
I'm not sure Jesus really liked being in that wilderness for 40 years.
Sijui kama Yesu alipenda kukaa pale nyikani kwa muda wote.
I don't know about you.
Na sijui kuhusu wewe.
After receiving such a powerful word.
Lakini baada ya kupokea neno kuu kama lile.
I want to go and manifest.
Mimi nataka niende na mfuate udhihirisho.
Between reception
katikati ya kupokea
or between conception
katikati ya kupokea
and manifestation
na kudhihirishwa
there is what tribulation
kuna hali ya mateso.
A woman has to go into labor.
Mwanamke lazima apitie utungu.
There's discomfort.
Kuna hali sio ya kuridhisha.
Those tribulations are not the kind of tribulations you think.
Na yale mateso si mateso ambayo unayafikiria.
You know, recently I learned something from Bishop.
Juzi tu nimesoma kitu kutoka kwa askofu.
When we were up north.
Wakati tulikuwa tumetembea mahali.
And he was telling another dear bishop.
Na alikuwa anamwambia askofu mwingine.
Do you know that the process?
Je, unajua ile hali
of taking corn from its cob?
Kutoa ama kudodoa zile begu za mahidi kutoka katika kobo lake
right?
Ni kuwa ni hali ya mateso.
You see, but for the corn to come out of the cob.
Lakini katika ile begu kuondoka.
And then can become many things.
Na ili ifanyike vitu nyingi.
It has to go through tribulations.
Lazima itapatia katika hali ya mateso.
That's why Jesus said.
Na ndio maana Yesu alisema.
In the world you would have tribulation.
Kwamba ulimwenguni mtapata mateso.
Tribulation is not to destroy you.
Lakini mateso si ya kukuangamiza.
Seasons don't destroy us.
Zile zamu hazituangamizi.
Seasons prepare us.
Ni kwamba zinatuandaa.
When we are in summer.
Wakati tuko katika hali ya hali,
not only do we enjoy the warmth of the weather.
Hatufurahii tu joto wa ile hali.
It is also preparing us.
Lakini pia huwa inatuandaa.
To begin to get our winter jackets out.
Ili tuweze kutayarisha koti zetu kwa sababu ya baridi.
So that we can take advantage.
Na ili kwamba tuchukue ile nafasi.
When winter season comes.
Wakati hali ya baridi inaingia.
So seasons of life.
Kwa hivyo zamu katika maisha.
They prepare us for the next level of life.
Tuandaa katika ile hali nyingine ambayo ya maisha.
Here to encourage somebody here tonight.
Niko hapa kumtia mtu moyo usiku leo.
What you are crying about?
Kile kitu unachokililia.
It's actually preparing you for a breakthrough.
Ni kwamba inakuondoa kwa sababu ya mwondoko mpya.
What you are worried about?
Na ambacho kinakusumbua.
It's preparing you for the greatest testimony of your life.
Ni kwa sababu ya ushuhuda mkuu wa maisha yako.
What you are crying about?
Ambacho unakililia.
It's about to open a big door for you.
Iko karibu kufungua milango mikuu kwako.
Because seasons of life.
Kwa sababu katika hali za maisha
they don't come to defeat us.
Hazikuji kutuangamiza.
They come to prepare us.
Lakini zinakuja kutuandaa.
And if you believe that shout a living amen.
Kama unaamini hao sema amina.
Like Joseph.
Kama Yusufu.
Had we not read the whole of his story.
Kama hatungekuwa tumesoma hadithi yake yote.
We would have concluded that Satan had the upper hand.
Tungefikiria ni kwamba shetani alikuwa na ushindi.
This man had a dream.
Huyu mtu alikuwa na ndoto.
He had a prophetic insight to God's plan for his life.
Na alikuwa anaona maneno ambayo yangekujia juu ya maisha yake.
What followed next after that conception?
Na ni nini kiliondokea baada ya hayo?
It was trial and tribulation.
Ilikuwa ni majaribu na mateso.
And if we have concluded his story too early.
Na kama tungeenda mpaka mwisho wa ile hadithi.
We would have said the devil had him.
Tukisema kwamba shetani alikuwa na ushindi.
But thank God we read his story.
Lakini nashukuru Mungu tulisoma hiyo hadithi.
And we read his story up unto the point.
Na tunasoma ile hadithi mpaka mahali.
When Joseph said to his brothers.
Wakati Yusufu aliwaambia ndugu zake.
What you meant for evil.
Ambacho mlimaanisha kwa uovu.
The Lord was preparing me for my good.
Mungu alikiandaa kwa wema wangu.
And that's why I've come to tell you tonight.
Ndio maana nimekuja kwa bishi kwa leo.
Don't conclude your matter too soon. Don't let anybody conclude your matter too soon.
Usiache mtu atimishe maneno yake kwa upesi.
Did you hear what I said?
Sikia nini nimesema.
Don't let anybody conclude you are done.
Usifanye mtu atie kikomo maisha
yako baraka. God is not done with you.
Mungu hajamalizana nawe.
God has only just started with you.
Mungu tu ameanzana na wewe.
Tell somebody sitting next to you.
Geukia mtu kando yako mwambie.
Don't conclude my story yet.
Ni kwamba usitie kikomo hadithi yangu.
Flip the page. Flip the page.
Fungua kurasa.
Tell them flip the page. page. Tell them, flip the page. Flip the page. You only just read one chapter. This book, there are many more chapters. The first chapter may not have interested you, but I guarantee you, if you become my friend for a long while, you will begin to see the juice in my story. You will begin to see the blessing in my story. You will begin to see the hand of God in my story. You will begin to see the favor of God in my story. You will begin to see the anointing of God in my story. Tell your neighbor, flip the page. You don't hear? I said, flip the page. Come to the next person, say, flip the page. You may know me yesterday as a prisoner, but don't conclude yet. There is a prime minister in this prisoner. You didn't hear what I said. As I don't conclude my story yet, it's only a season. I am only going through. I am not stopping. It's only a passing through. Follow me and you shall see that there is a king in this shepherd boy. You didn't hear what I said. Don't conclude my story too soon. Flip the page. Come on, shout, flip the page. Say, flip the page. Oh my God, my God. Amen. I see the hand of the Lord flipping somebody's page to the best part of your life. Oh, weeping may have endured in the past. Chapter 1, weeping. Chapter 2, weeping. Chapter 3, weeping. Chapter 4, weeping. Chapter 5, weeping. Before you conclude, it's a sad story. Oh, flip one more page. It's just about to get better. It's just about to get hot. It's just about to get loud. If you believe it, shout, flip the page. Don't conclude yet. Don't conclude yet. Just when you think it's over, Jehovah Rapha steps in. Jehovah Sikenu steps in. The Lion of the Tribe of Judah steps in. The I Am That I Am steps in. The God who is God all by himself steps in. Tonight I see the Lord stepping in. I came with a prophetic word in my spirit. This is tonight the Lord is stepping in. Every barrenness is terminated tonight. Barrenness in business, barrenness in career, barrenness in marriage, barrenness in ministry, barrenness all around you. Tonight, barrenness is over. In the name of Jesus, everything that may have seen concluded in your life, tonight I come to declare by the power and the authority of God, the pages are flipping. The pages are flipping. The pages are flipping in your favor. In the name of Jesus. Satan, I bind you in this house tonight. I shut your mouth up. I tell you, Satan, the pages of these people is flipping tonight. I came as a sent one. I came as an ambassador. I came as an apostle to nation. And I decree and declare the pages of their life is flipping tonight for the best part of their story. If you believe it, shout amen. Please take your seat quickly. Don't conclude yet. 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 It's going to get better. And it's going to get better and better. And let me warn you of two major dangers in this season. There are two major dangers that you are post with in this season. When you begin to go through season, there are two things that you need to be careful of. The first one is the decisions you make. Seasons always demand decision making from us.
Ni kwamba inaangalia katika uamuzi ambao
tunafanya. You learn how to do it the God way.
Kwamba utafanya katika mapenzi ya Mungu.
Or you do it your way.
Ama utafanya kwa njia zako.
Or you do it the devil's way.
Ama utafanya katika njia
zake. The second thing you have to be careful of.
Jambo la pili hatarishi.
Is the attempt to escape the season.
Ni ile hali ya kupotea katika zile zamu.
The season must run its course. It's like a semester.
Ile zamu lazima ipite kwa ukamilifu.
When you get admission into university.
Wakati unaenda katika chuo kikuu.
All your program is divided into semesters.
Ni kwamba kuna zamu tatu ambazo zimegawanywa katika ile
program. No matter how the course may be difficult.
Haijalishi ile kosi yako itakuwa ngumu namna gani.
Let the course run its course.
Lazima itaenda na ikamilike.
You must let the semester run its course.
Lazima ule muhula uende na ufike mwisho.
If you avoid the first semester.
Kama hutaingia katika muhula wa kwanza.
You cannot arrive in the second semester.
Hutaenda muhula wa pili.
For you to go to another level.
Ili uende katika hatua nyingine.
You have to go through the process.
Lazima utapitia ile
hali. Somebody said process.
Mtu asema muondoko.
Process is what makes anything of worth valuable.
Hiyo muondoko ndio unafanya kila kitu kiwe cha dhamana.
And if you excuse yourself for process.
Kama hutapitia katika ule muondoko.
You will not arrive at the purposes of God for your life.
Hautafikia katika kusudi la Mungu maishani mwako.
So don't try to find alternative routes.
Kwa hivyo usitafute njia mbadala.
Israel had to go through the wilderness.
Waisraeli lazima wangepitia nyikani.
So do not attempt to go to abort your process.
Kwa hivyo usipotelee katika ile muondoko.
Many people have aborted their process.
Watu wengi wameafia ule muondoko.
In Luke chapter 18.
Katika Luka 18.
We were told of the adversary.
Tunaambiwa kwa maadui.
We were told of the unrighteous judge.
Ni kwamba hakimu wako.
And we were told of the widow.
Na tunaambiwa kuhusu mwanamke mjane.
Injustice had been done to her.
Ni kwamba mara mama awe mambo ametufanyikia.
She needed justice.
Na kwamba alitaka haki kupata haki yake.
She understands process.
Lakini alijua hali ya mondoko.
The Bible says she kept going back to the judge.
Yeye anasema alizidi kwenda kwa ule hakimu.
Give me justice.
Na akamwambia nipe haki.
Day and night she kept going back.
Usiku kwa mchana alimwendea.
She did not mind going back.
Hakujali kurejea pale.
Because she understands Psalm 30 verse 5.
Kwa sababu alielewa.
That weeping may endure for the night.
Ni kwamba kilio cha endelee usiku.
But justice will follow.
Lakini haki
itakuwa. So she kept going back for justice.
Alizidi kwenda kupata
haki. And eventually she got justice.
Na baada yake akapata haki
zake. She was relentless in her faith.
Yeye hakukoma katika imani.
Jesus said,
na Yesu akasema,
when I come back again,
wakati nitarejea,
this is the kind of church I want to find.
Ndio mtu ambaye ningetaka kumpata.
A relentless church.
Ni kanisa ambalo halikomi.
That will endure the seasons.
Kanisa ambalo halikomi katika majira.
A church that will submit to process.
Ni kanisa ambalo litakaa katika muondoko.
Until they get their reward.
Hadi wakati watapata
zawadi. I sense in my spirit even right now.
Nasikia katika roho yangu.
That some of you have been in a process for a while.
Kuna wengi wamekuwa katika ile muondoko.
You've been asking Lord, when will this end?
Kwamba katika mwisho huu.
Well, I came from United States of America.
Kwamba kuna mgeni kutoka
America. To tell you this weekend.
Kukwambia katika wiki hii.
Justice will be served.
Kwamba haki.
You will receive.
Kwamba utapokea.
The fruit of your waiting.
Katika utarajio wako.
The Bible says follow those who through faith and patience.
Biblia inasema kwa kufuatilia
obtain their promises.
Ni kwamba walipata ahadi zao.
I hear the Lord say,
nasikia Yesu
akisema, you have been waiting patiently.
Kwamba umesubiri kwa subira.
You've been waiting in faith.
Unatarajia kwa imani.
And this weekend something is about to shift in your favor.
Kitu kitaondoka.
Oh, this is, you didn't hear what I just said. I said you've been waiting patiently.
Kwamba umesubiri kwa subira.
You've been waiting in faith.
Unatarajia kwa imani.
But this weekend,
lakini weekend,
I hear the spirit of the Lord say something, something supernatural is moving in your favor. I tell you the honest truth, church, this weekend God is set to do somebody good, and it will be marvelous in our eyes because you have not compromised. God is moving in your favor in the name of Jesus. Listen to me.
Nisikize.
I want to share quickly.
Nataka kwa upesi.
Four things you need to do.
Mambo manne ambayo
unafaa kufanya. When you go through seasons.
Wakati unapitia majira.
They will not only keep you in the seasons, but they will bring you into your blessed season. Remember, God is taking somebody from wilderness to blessedness, but there is a process in between, and there are things you must know and do for you to maintain yourself whilst you are going through that season, and for you to come into your blessedness. Somebody, you cannot escape this. You are coming in your blessedness. When I was praying, the Lord spoke to me about a woman, and he said, you have received an advice in your time of season, and that advice took you off course. The effect of that advice is what you are suffering from tonight. And I stood in your gap in the place of prayer. I said, Lord, have mercy, Lord. Lord, do something. And the Lord spoke to me that as I preach tonight, the negative effect of the advice you received will be nullified tonight, and you will find yourself in the place that God wants you to go, and you will begin to see lines falling onto you in pleasant places. If you are that person, I want you to receive the promise of God. I want you to receive a word for you that no longer would you be a victim of negative advice. It's like Elkanah saying to Anna, he said, why do you worry about your child? I love you more than 10 sons. Whilst that was a good statement, it was not a destiny statement. There is a difference between a good advice and a destiny advice. And tonight I stand as a prophet of God. Every good advice, every well-meaning advice that have taken you off course, we stand against them tonight. We decree and declare that only the voice of God will you hear. Tonight we excuse you from the consequences of negative advice, of good advice but not godly advice. By the blood of the Lamb, we apply it over you, and we exempt you from these consequences in the name of Jesus. If you believe it, shout amen. Number one, what must you do when God is taking you to a season? The first thing you do, maintain a knowledge of who you are. Maintain the knowledge of who you truly are. You remember the temptation of the enemy that tempted Jesus with. He said, if you are the Son of God, if you are the Son of God, listen to me. In Luke chapter 3, verse 21, the voice of God
sauti ya
went forth
ikatoka
and said, this is my beloved son.
Na ikasema, huu ni mwana wangu
nipendaye. Go to the next verse. Go to the next verse. 22.
Ukienda ukura, aya 22.
Look at what he says. He said, this is my beloved son.
Ni kwamba huu ni mwana wangu nipendaye.
I am well pleased.
Ambao nafurahishwa sana naye.
God already declared who Christ was in.
Ni kwamba Mungu alitangaza Yesu yeye ni nani.
And now the devil comes and say, if you are the son of God.
Na shetani anaja anamwambia wapo wewe ni mwana wa Mungu.
It's an old trick in the book of the enemy.
Ni kwamba ile ni jaribio ambalo ni zee sana katika
ile kama. The greatest battle you and I will fight in life is the great battle of identity in Christ.
Vita ambazo tunapigana mimi na wewe maisha ni za wewe ni nani.
The enemy knows what it can confuse you of who you are.
Na shetani anajua kwamba akikuchanganya kujua wewe ni nani atakushinda maisha.
Why must you hold on to the identity of who you are?
Ni kwa nini ushike katika utangulio ama kujua wewe ni nani?
When you go through seasons in life,
ukipitia yale majira katika maisha,
there is a tendency,
kuna ile hali,
that you begin to evaluate yourself based on the season in the life.
Unaanza kujikagua wewe ni nani kulingana na yale majira.
You begin to see yourself.
Unaanza kujiona wewe.
If care is not taken,
kama wewe hujatahadhari,
feel filter of that season.
Kupitia katika yale majira.
But like I already said,
lakini vile
seasons don't define you and I.
Baba majira haimaanishi wewe ni nani.
Seasons prepare us for the next big thing.
Lakini majira yanatutayarisha kwa sababu ya kile kitu kingine.
That should define you and I.
Kile kitu ambacho kibazo kinafaa kutanguliza mimi na wewe.
It's the word of the Lord concerning me.
Neno la Mungu nasema nini kunihusu.
That's why Jesus said.
Na ndio maana Yesu akasema.
That man shall not live by bread alone.
Baba mtu hataishi kwa mkate peke.
Because today there can be plenty.
Ni kwamba leo kunaweza kuwa na utere.
Tomorrow there can be scarcity.
Na kesho kutakuwa na ukiwa.
And if you have defined yourself by bread.
Na kama ulijitanguliza kwa mkate.
Your life will go up and down.
Maisha yako itaenda juu na chini.
Your self esteem will go up and down.
Ni kwamba hadhi yako itapanda juu na chini.
You would lack identity.
Ni kwamba wewe hutapata kitambulisho.
There's no scarcity or shortage with the word of God.
Kama kutakuwa na ukiwa na upungufu wa neno.
In fact, what God gives to you when you go through stuff is his word.
Lakini Mungu ambacho anakupatia ukipitia hali ni neno lake.
And the integrity of the word of God stands.
Na hakikisho la neno la Mungu linasimama.
The word of God.
Na neno la Mungu.
The integrity of God's word.
Ni kwamba ni neno la Mungu.
It's not the same as our political structure.
Si kama hali zetu za kisiasa.
There is no stability in our political structure.
Hakuna kusimama imara katika hali zetu za kisiasa.
The integrity of our political structure has failed us.
Na hali zao za kusimama kwao zimetuangusha sana.
It is not reliable and dependable.
Hatuwezi tukazitegemea.
So if you allow what is going on in the nation to define you.
Kama utafanya kutambulisha kulingana mambo yanayotendeka nchini.
When things go down, you go down.
Wakati mambo yanaenda chini, unaenda chini nayo.
You begin to estimate yourself by that standard.
Na unaanza kujitambulisha kwa yale mambo.
But the integrity of God's word has never failed.
Lakini neno la Bwana halijai tuacha.
And so when you receive what God says concerning you.
Na ndio maana unapokea ni nini Yesu amesema kuhusu wewe.
It doesn't matter what you go through.
Haijarishi unapitia nini.
It doesn't matter the seasons of life.
Na haijarishi majira ya maisha.
Your belief is firm.
Ni kwamba huamini kwako ni imara.
Your estimate is intact.
Na hadhi yako iko simama.
Because seasons have never defined you.
Ni kwamba majira haija kutambulisha wewe.
I've met people when there's money.
Na kuna watu wakati wana pesa.
Everybody know they just receive the salary.
Ni kwamba kila mtu atajua umepokea mshahara.
Everybody know they just hit the jackpot.
Kila mtu atajua kwamba ameshinda kitu.
They're excited.
Wao wanasisimuka sana.
Very confident.
Na kwamba wanaukakamavu.
But the moment they go through a season.
Lakini wakati wanapitia majira mengine ya maisha.
The same way everybody knows.
Kila mtu atajua pia.
That something is wrong with him.
Ni kwamba kuna kitu.
And everybody begins to act.
Na kila mtu anaanza kuuliza.
Brother, is everything okay?
Kuna kitu kila kitu iko sawa. Uko sawa dada?
Is well.
Iko sawa.
It's just that he has lost his identity.
Ni kwamba tu amepoteza ule utambulisho wake.
There's nothing wrong with him.
Si kitu chochote kibaya
naye. It's only a loss of identity.
Lakini amepoteza utambulisho wake.
You need to understand.
Unafaa ufahamu.
The seasons will come.
Kwamba majira yatakujia.
But the word of God remains forever.
Lakini neno la Bwana linasimama imara.
The word of God says concerning you and I.
Na kwamba neno la Mungu linasimama kuhusu wewe na mimi. Haijarishi nini inaja.
That is who we are.
Lakini sisi ni
wale. That is who I am.
Ndio ndiye mimi.
So that's why Jesus said.
Na ndio maana Yesu akasema.
I don't need to prove to you I'm the son of God.
Kwamba sifai kukuhakikishia kwamba ni mwana wa Mungu.
The moment you begin to prove yourself.
Wakati unaanza kwamba kukuhakikishia.
You are never sure of what you are.
Ni kwamba hutaonekana wewe ni nani.
You means you are never sure of what you are.
Ni kumaanisha kwamba wewe hauna uhakika wewe ni nani.
Please do not define yourself.
Kwa hivyo usijitambulisha wewe mwenyewe.
By the temporary situation you are going through.
Kwa hali za kupitia ambazo unazipata.
I have gone through seasons in my life.
Nimepitia majira tofauti maishani.
As a believer.
Kama muumini.
And in the early stage.
Na katika zile hatua za
kwanza.
Nikaanza kuwa na shaka moyoni.
As a young pastor.
Nikasema mchunga.
As a young minister.
Nime kama mtu wa
Mungu. Seasons happen in my ministry.
Kama majira yamepita maisha.
In the church I pastored.
Na kanisa bado na hudumu.
I will begin to think.
Naanza kufikiria.
I am not good enough.
Mimi si bora.
I remember.
Nikakumbuka.
When God began to transition me.
Wakati Mungu alianza kuniondoa.
Into my apostolic ministry.
Na akaniweka katika hali ya utume.
I will fight a battle.
Nilipigana vita.
From where I took the plane.
Kuanzia mahali nilipotoka.
To the nation I was going.
Baka inchi ambako nilikuwa
naenda. I will tell myself.
Na ninge
because I have accepted the lie of the devil.
Kwa sababu nimepokea
uongo. That what do you have to say to the nations?
Utasema nini kwa mataifa?
You how many members is your church?
Wewe uko na watu wangapi kanisa?
How many people do you pastor?
Una watu wangapi unahudumia?
What are the results you have gotten?
Ni nini matokeo yako ni?
Have you forgotten what you've been through?
Umesahau nini umepitia?
So what do you have to say in the nations?
Je, una nini ya kusema mataifani?
And I will fight myself.
Na ningepikana.
All the way to where I'm going to.
Paka mahali nilikuwa naenda.
I accepted I was an hypocrite.
Nikapokea kwamba mimi ni kwa
tu. And so when I get to those places.
Wakati nilifika
zile sehemu. And I begin to minister.
Nikaanza kuhudumu.
I begin to train pastors.
Na naanza kuwafunza wachungaji.
The power of God will break out.
Kuhusu nguvu za
Mungu. The wisdom of God will flow.
Na hekima ya Mungu ijeondoka.
People will be greatly helped.
Na ige ni kwa msaada
sana. And of course,
na kwa sababu
I was so quick
na nilikuwa
after those meetings
kupitia katika
because I was afraid
kwa sababu
for
na
people to say what is the size of your church.
Na kanisa lako na
so before they even ask me,
kwa hivyo, mtu mwingine akaniuliza,
I will be quickly to say,
ningekuwa haraka
kusema, oh, we just pastor a small church alone.
Kwa sababu kanisa lake ni kidogo.
Our ministry is not that big.
Na huduma yake si kubwa.
Because the enemy
ni kwa sababu adui
successfully lied to me.
Alikuwa amenidanganya.
I was an hypocrite.
Kwamba mimi nilikuwa mtu
usi. Have what it takes.
Kwamba lakini kwa na kile kitu
ambacho tunapitia.
Na tunapitia yale
sisi wote. But I thank God for the word of God.
Lakini nashukuru Mungu kwa neno lake.
I thank God when the word of the Lord entered into me.
Wakati neno lake liingia ndani yangu.
And God began to show me.
Na akaanza kunionyesha.
That the size of the church.
Kwamba ukuu wa kanisa.
It's not what validates my calling.
Sio ile ambayo inamaanisha mwito wangu.
Jesus at this point in Luke chapter 3.
Yesu katika Luka 3.
Was not a mega church pastor.
Yeye hakuwa na kanisa kubwa.
He was just a son of God.
Yeye alikuwa tu ni mwana wa Mungu.
The Lord said to me.
Ni kwamba Bwana
It is because you are going, you have allowed men to box you in a title.
Ni kwa sababu na uruhusu watu wakuweke katika ile hali.
You have allowed men to box you in an office.
Na umeruhusu watu wakuweka katika ofisi.
But if you are simply a son of God.
Lakini wewe kama ni mwana wa Mungu.
There is no expectation other than God in your life.
Hakuna tarajio lingine ila tu ni Bwana maishani.
Once you say you are a pastor of a church.
Na unaposema kwamba wewe ni pastor wa kanisa.
Then there's an unhealthy expectation.
Na kuna kutarajio rajia akusipo kwa hali njema na Bwana akasema
be comfortable in me yourself as my son
kama wewe kama mwana wangu
as my daughter
ama kama binti yangu
and there is no limit
na hakuna kitu cha sitiri
to what I would do through you
abacho kwa yale mambo ambayo
naweza kufanya because in the first place
kwa sababu kwa hali ya kwanza
God did not ask me to grow a church pastoring
Bwana hakuniita kuwa wa kanisa kuu
God wanted me to pastor a church to grow me as an apostle
Bwana alitaka kanisa linde kama mtume
and once my training was over after 9 years
nilijua kwamba kufunzwa kwangu kulikuwa baada ya miaka 9
the Lord said to me like he said to Jeremiah
Bwana akaninenea kama alivyomnenea Jeremiah
I ordained you as a prophet and apostle to the nation.
Baba nilikutuma kama nabii na
mtume kwa mataifa. And get going.
Nikoba chukua mkoba wako uondoke.
What I could not do in 9 years of pastoring.
Abacho nisingefanya kwa miaka 9 ya
uchungaji. I have done uncountable, unimaginable in 5 years.
Nifanya vitu vingi sana kwa miaka 5.
The church I could not grow.
Kwa kanisa bado singeendelea.
Today I oversee churches in numbers.
Leo naangalia makanisa mengi sana.
Today I pastor pastors.
Leo hii nilikuwa nawahudumia mapasa.
Because I found my identity in Christ.
Kwa sababu nilipata utambulisho wangu kwa Kristo.
And so what am I saying to you tonight?
Nasema nini kwenu usiku leo?
That when you are going through season.
Wakati unapitia majira.
Maintain the knowledge of who you are in Christ.
Ishe kwamba unafahamu wewe ni nani katika
Jesus Kristo. Jesus stood his ground.
Kristo akasimama katika hali yake.
I don't need to prove anything to you.
Sifai kuhakikishia chochote.
I know who I am.
Lakini najua mimi ni nani.
I know who I am.
Najua mimi utambulisho
wangu. Because if you lose your identity.
Kwa sababu ukipoteza
You lose your authority. If you lose your identity, you lose your ability. If you lose your identity, you lose your community. If you lose your identity, you lose your prosperity. Identity is what precedes authority. Identity is what reveals ability. Identity is what defines your community. Identity is what determines your prosperity. That's another sermon for another day. A season of setback doesn't mean you are backward. A season of setback
katika hamaha
hali ya kurudi nyuma backward
haimaanishi wewe ni mtu wa kinyume
it's only a setup for a comeback
inamaanisha tu ni hatua kwa kupanda kuu
I want to end this point with this statement
nataka kutimisha kwa kusema hili
what the devil does not know
abacho shetani hajui
that you must know very well
abacho wewe unafaa kujua vizuri sana
is that you advance in adversity
ni kwamba wewe unanawiri katika hali ya mateso
the devil does not know it
Lakini shetani hajui hayo.
Up till now.
Mpaka sasa.
Up till now he doesn't know.
Paka sasa hafahamu.
And he will not know.
Na hata jua.
He will not know.
Hata jua.
But it is okay for the devil not to know.
Lakini ni sawa kwa shetani, kutopajua.
But you and I must know.
Lakini wewe na mimi sharti tujue.
That we actually advance in adversity.
Ni kwamba sisi tunanawiri katika hali ya mateso.
That's why 1 Corinthians chapter 2 says.
Ya maana wa Korintho wa kwanza 2 inasema.
If the rulers of this world had known.
Kama viongozi wa hii dunia wangelifahamu.
They would not have crucified Jesus.
Ni kwamba hawangemsulubisha Yesu.
Because I believe it was a shocker.
Kwa sababu naamini kwamba ilikuwa ya ajabu kwao.
That the very thing Satan wanted to stop.
Kwa sababu kile kitu ambacho shetani alitaka kusimamisha.
By eliminating Jesus.
Na kuiondoa kwa kumuua Yesu.
He actually activated that blessing.
Ni kwamba alitia moto sana kwa ile baraka.
That's what the scripture further says.
Na ndio maana Biblia inasema.
Eyes have not seen.
Ni kwamba macho hayajaona na macho hayajasikia.
Neither has it been conceived in the heart of man.
Haijapatikana katika moyo wa mtu.
The precious things God has for you and I.
Mambo ya dhamana ambayo Mungu ametuwekea.
Those things could only have been activated by the death of Jesus.
Yale mambo yalipatikana kwa kifo cha Yesu.
Why the devil thought he was doing himself good?
Kwa sababu mahali ya shetani alifikiria anafanya vyema.
By killing Jesus.
Kwa kumuua Yesu.
He actually did good to us.
Alikifikiria natenda mabaya alitutendea vizuri.
So I'm sure the devil was shocked when David showed up.
Najua shetani alishangaa wakati Daudi aliinuka.
Before Goliath.
Na akasimama mbele ya Goliath.
And they pulled all the experiences of the wilderness out.
Na akaziondoa zile tajriba za nyikani zote.
I'm sure the devil will be like, "Yeah."
Lazima shetani alikuwa kama
I thought I subject you behind the scene.
Nilifikiria kwamba nimekuweka bali sana.
I thought you were dealing with rejection.
Na nafikiria ulikuwa unapigana na kukataliwa.
I thought you were a non-entity at the backside rearing sheep.
Nilifikiria wewe uko tu huko nyuma unalisha kondoo.
So I did not know.
Na sikujua.
You were gaining strength at the backside.
Ni kwamba ulikuwa na nguvu sana kwa.
You were gaining experience at the backside.
Ni kwamba ulipokuwa unapata taji la kuku.
So those seasons were preparing you for your greatest victory.
Kwa hivyo yale majira yanakuandaa ni kwa sababu ya ushindi.
And David said.
Na Daudi akasema.
You showed up as a bear.
Yeye alisimama pale pamoja na duba.
I killed you.
Na akamuua.
You showed up as a lion.
Na ukaonekana kama
simba. I killed you.
Na nikakuua.
You didn't know what you were doing.
Haukujua unatenda nini.
You were giving me experience and strength.
Ulikuwa unanipa nguvu na tajriba.
Listen to me.
Nisikize.
What you are going through.
Jambo unalolipitia.
Is preparing you.
Inakuandaa.
For your greatest victory in life.
Sababu ya ushindi wako.
So don't give up on who you are.
Kwa hivyo usikate tamaa wewe ni nani.
In the battles of life as believers.
Katika vita za maisha kama waumini.
We will stand strong.
Tutasimama imara.
Only until we give up the identity of who we are in Christ.
Wakati tutajua sisi ni nani katika
Kristo. Number two that you must know.
Jambo la pili ambalo lazima tujue.
Spiritual decision.
Ni kwamba ufanye amuzi.
Not quality decision.
Za kiroho lakini si za kidhamana.
Did you hear what I said? Make spiritual decisions.
Ni kwamba ufanye uamuzi wa kiroho.
Not quality decisions.
Lakini si za kidhamana.
It was a quality decision.
Ni katika zile amuzi
ambazo Jesus to have turned the stone into bread.
Za Yesu kubadilisha jiwe liwe mkate.
The enemy wanted him to make a decision.
Shetani alitaka yeye amue.
The Bible says for 40 days he had ate nothing. He was hungry.
Kwa siku 40 alikuwa amekula hakujakula chochote alikuwa na njaa.
It was only right for him to break his fast, right?
Ilikuwa ni sawa kwake kujifungua.
So to provide himself with a meal after 40 days is a quality decision.
Na ili ajitwalie chakula baada ya siku 40 ilikuwa ni uamuzi mzuri.
Speaking.
Sana sana tukiongea.
But there is a difference between a quality decision.
Lakini kuna tofauti ya uamuzi wa kibusara.
A spiritual decision.
Na uamuzi wa kiroho.
And when we go through seasons.
Na wakati tunapitia katika majira.
You will be faced with decision making moments.
Utapata hali ambazo inakubidi ufanye uamuzi.
Jesus said, I don't need to turn this stone.
Yesu akasema hainifai mimi kubadilisha jiwe liwe mkate.
Because I don't have the power to do so.
Si kwa sababu sina uwezo wa kufanya vile.
5000 men needed to eat.
Lakini watu 5000 walipaswa kula.
I multiplied bread.
Na mimi nikajumlisha mikate.
It's not an issue for me.
Kwa hivyo hilo sio jambo kwangu.
But if I make the decision to do this.
Lakini nikiamua kutenda hili.
It will be against the will of God.
Na itakuwa kinyume na mapenzi ya Bwana.
Therefore I must make a spiritual decision.
Kwa hivyo lazima nifanye uamuzi wa kiroho.
It is not there's nothing right.
Hakuna kitu sawa
about the decision that Daniel made.
Kuhusu uamuzi ambao Daniel alifanya.
Many of us today would gladly settle for the king's delicacy.
Ilikuwa labda wakefurahia kukula katika chakula cha mfalme.
Daniel said, give me vegetables.
Lakini akasema hapana, nipe boga.
And there was nothing quality about that decision.
Hakukuwa na kitu cha maana sana kuhusu ile uamuzi alifanya.
But there was everything spiritual about that decision.
Lakini ulikuwa ni uamuzi wa kiroho sana.
When the enemy begins to confront you with decision making moments.
Wakati shetani anaanza kukuletea hali za kufanya uamuzi.
Don't let what you are going through inform your decision.
Usifanye kitu ambacho unakipitia kikusaidie kufanya uamuzi.
Let the voice of the Holy Spirit.
Lakini wacha sauti ya Roho Mtakatifu.
Let the leading of the Holy Spirit.
Na muongozo wa Roho Mtakatifu.
Help you make that decision.
Ukusaidie kufanya uamuzi.
Because once you make a spiritual decision.
Kwa sababu unapofanya uamuzi wa kiroho.
Not only will he guard you through that season.
Ni kwamba Mungu atakuongoza katika
majira. This is what transports you into your blessedness.
Lakini hili litakupelekea katika kubarikiwa kwako.
It says the path of the just.
Biblia inasema njia ya wenye haki.
It is not every path.
Sio njia zozote.
In Psalm 16 verse 11.
Ah, Zaburi 16:11.
It says you will show me the path of life.
Ni kwamba unanionyesha njia za maisha.
In your presence.
Ni kwamba katika uwepo wako.
So the path of life.
Katika njia za maisha.
It's as a result of spiritual decision.
Ni kutokana na uamuzi wa kiroho.
And I pray in the name of Jesus.
Naomba katika jina la Yesu.
That God will help somebody under the sound of my voice.
Mungu atamsaidia mtu anayenisikiza.
To make a spiritual decision.
Afanye uamuzi wa kiroho.
In what you are going through.
Kwa jambo ambalo unalipitia.
Because it will take you into your levels.
Kwa sababu itakupelekea katika hali yako nyingine katika jina la Yesu.
Quickly, number 3. We have 2 more, we go.
Nambari 3.
Let nothing else take your worship.
Usiache chochote kipaa kichukue ibada yako.
Satan took him up to the pinnacle.
Ya shetani alimpelekea katika hekalu pale juu.
All the kingdoms belong to me.
Na kama mbizi farme zote nimetwaliwa.
If you bow down and worship me.
Ukininamia tu kidogo niabudu.
And Jesus said,
na Yesu akasema,
you shall worship no other god.
Unafaa kumwabudu tu Mungu.
Except God.
Usimwabudu mwingine yote. Nisikize.
I'm going to be very brief with this.
Nataka kuwa kwa kupesi sana.
You see, there is a tendency.
Kuna hali ama inatokea.
That when you go through seasons.
Wakati unapita katika majira.
That you begin to give worship.
Unaanza kuabudu ama kutoa ibada.
To whatever gives you some form of respite.
Kwa kitu ambacho kinakupatia tulizo.
Church of Jesus.
Na kanisa la Bwana.
Man can give you respite.
Ni kwamba mtu anaweza kupa tu tulizo.
But know this.
Lakini
respite is not the same thing as rest.
Ni kwamba ile tulizo si kama pumziko.
Respite is a temporary thing.
Ile tulizo ni muda tu kidogo.
Rest is a permanent status in Christ.
Lakini pumziko ni kitu cha maisha katika Yesu.
Because you see, when we go through seasons.
Wakati tunapita katika majira.
It's a season sometimes of deprivation.
Ni majira wakati mwingine ya kupungukiwa.
It's very lonely.
Na kwa upweke sana.
And so any form of relief that shows up.
Hali yoyote ya tulizo kidogo.
If you are not careful.
Kama hauko makini.
You will begin to worship that thing.
Utaanza kuabudu hali ile.
Listen to me, when I was pastoring.
Unisikize, wakati nilikuwa mchungaji.
As a pastor.
Nikiwa mchanga.
Especially in Europe.
Wow, sana sana pale Uingereza.
I have been in ministry in Africa and Nigeria.
Nimekuwa katika huduma hapa Afrika pale Nigeria.
I was part of a mega church.
Nilikuwa kwa kanisa kubwa sana.
A church of 50,000 members now.
Kanisa la watu 1,050 sasa.
There's always been resources.
Na kumekuwa na rasilimali.
As pastors for us to do everything we want to do.
Kwa hivyo kitanda chochote tungelitaka.
But here was I planting a new church.
Lakini niko hapa napanda kanisa mpya.
And you can imagine what that is.
Unaweza tafakari ilikuwa vipi?
Sometimes you go without even having help.
Wakati mwingine unaenda bila hata msaada.
You are everything in the church.
Wewe ni kila kitu kanisani.
You are the janitor, you open the door.
Wewe ndiye wa kwanza pale hata kufungua mlango.
My wife, we are the cleaner.
Mimi na mke wangu tulikuwa tunaosha pale.
We are the ushers.
Na sisi tulikuwa shamans.
We set up the chair.
Na sisi tunaweka viti.
We clean the chair.
Na tunapanguza.
We set up the sound system.
Tunaweka vyombo pale.
We do mic test.
Tunafanya
check 1 check 2 check 3.
Microphone venye inafanya
kazi. Projector must be properly stationed.
Tunaweka projector vizuri.
We do everything.
Unafanya kila kitu.
Sometimes nobody shows up.
Wakati mwingine hakuna
yeyote. You go out on evangelism.
Tunaenda katika uinjilisti.
You give out flyers, you talk to people.
Tunaenda kunena na watu.
You win souls, you tell them to come to church.
Tunawaambia waje kanisani.
They promise you they will come to church.
Tunasema watakuja kanisani.
Sunday you are excited.
Kwa hivyo unakuwa
na souls we want are coming to church.
Kama kuna watu watakuja.
But Sunday comes, nobody shows up.
Lakini Jumapili hakuna anatokea.
You preach to your wife.
Unahubiria mke wako.
Then we grew the church.
Na kwamba tukakuza ni kanisa.
By my daughter.
Kwa dada yake.
So sometimes you preach to your wife and your daughter.
Unaanza kumhubiria mke
wako. They grew the church again by another child.
Kwa hivyo tukakuza kanisa.
There was a conference we had.
Kulikuwa na mkutano tulikuwa nao.
It was packed.
na ilikuwa imejaa kabisa.
Packed with my wife and my two children.
Na kulikuwa ni mke wangu na watoto wangu waliokuwa pale katika ule mkutano.
Preach the word with fire.
Na nikanena neno kwa moto.
But of course I went home crying to the Lord.
Na nikaenda kumlilia Bwana.
Because my heart was broken.
Kwa sababu roho yangu ilikuwa imevujika.
And gradually.
Na kwa upole pole pole tu.
So one or two people shows up.
Watu wawili wakaanza
kusema. And they say I can take care of this department.
Na wanaanza kusema nitashughulikia.
I have experience where I'm coming from.
Niko na tajriba mahali nimetoka.
Suddenly.
Kwa upole pole tu.
They started becoming my gods.
Ndaanza kuwa msaada kwa.
Because I finally had respite.
Kwa sababu nilipata tulizo tu kidogo.
It took me a while to know the difference between respite and rest.
Ilichukua muda sana kujua tulizo na pumziko.
Some of these people that came.
Watu wengine ambao walikuja.
They gave me respite from doing all of those things.
Walinipatia tulizo za kufanya tu zile vitu nilikuwa.
But they never gave me rest to fulfill the call of God on my life.
Lakini hawakunipatia nafasi ya kufanya nini.
One day I was on mission. I was on mission trip.
Nilikuwa katika mission pale
nimetoka. And I heard a voice of the Lord clearly said to me.
Nikasikia sauti ya Bwana ikiniambia.
He said if you make a god out of your members.
Nikaniambia kwamba ukifanya Mungu kwa wale watu wa kanisa lako.
Then you would have to excuse me from that ministry.
Ni kwamba mimi utaniruhusu niondoke katika ile
huduma. I went back to England that day.
Nikarudi pale Uingereza hiyo siku.
And it was the last time.
Na ilikuwa ni wakati wangu wa mwisho.
That I ever settled for respite.
Ambayo nilipata tulizo.
Because I knew the difference between rest and respite.
Kwa sababu nilijua tofauti ya tulizo na pumziko.
I flow from the place of absolutely rest in God.
Kwa sababu wakati huu niko katika hali ya utulizo kamili
ya Mungu. That's why I have never knocked on one door.
Ndio maana sijabisha mlango.
To come and preach anywhere.
Niende nihubiri mahali.
I have never, it will never happen.
And sijawahi na haitaifanyika.
Because that is from a place of what of ability, self ability.
Kwa sababu itaonekana ni kama uwezo
wangu. Therefore there remains a promise of rest.
Ni kwamba kumeahidiwa upumziko.
When you maintain faith in your season.
Wakati una imani katika majira yako.
You operate from the place of rest.
Ni kwamba unafanya kazi katika hali ya pumziko.
Because those who did not enter the rest according to Hebrews chapter 4.
Kwa Ibrania 4 ambao hawakuingia katika pumziko.
Was because faith was missing.
Ni kwa sababu hawakuwa na imani.
The seasons of life.
Kuna majira ya maisha.
Requires you to maintain your worship to God alone.
Ambayo inakufanya ama inakubidi uhakikishe unamwabudu Mungu.
Let me say this last thing on this point.
Niseme hili kwa hili jambo.
Don't settle for the stool when the throne is yours.
Usikae pale katika stool wakati kuna kiti cha enzi umewekewa.
Don't settle for the stool.
Ni kwamba usipate pumziko pale kwa stool
when the throne is yours.
Wakati kiti cha enzi ni chako.
The Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
the heavens is the throne of God.
Ni kwamba mbingu ndicho kiti cha Mungu.
The earth is his footstool.
Na ulimwengu ni pumziko la miguu yake.
What Satan was promising Jesus was a footstool.
Abacho Shetani alikuwa anamwahidia Yesu ni pumziko la miguu.
Do you get it now?
Je, waipata?
What Satan was promising him.
Abacho Shetani alikuwa anamwahidia Yesu.
Was only a footstool.
Ilikuwa tu ni pumziko la miguu yake.
Many have settled for footstool.
Na wengi wamepata pumziko pale.
God has prepared a throne for you.
Ni hali Mungu ameandaa kiti kwao.
You settled for the wrong man because you couldn't wait for the right man.
Ulipata mume ambaye si hasa kwa sababu hungepata subira.
You settled for the wrong woman because you couldn't wait for the right man.
Ama ulipata bibi si yule kwa sababu hukupata subira.
You settled for what for an underpaid job because you couldn't trust God for his promise for your life.
Ama ulipata kazi hailipi vizuri kwa sababu hukupata na subira kwa Mungu.
And you began to worship what came temporarily when God has something big for you.
Na unaanza kuabudu ambacho kimekuja kwa muda ili hali Mungu ana kitu cha mkuu.
Today I want to challenge you.
Leo nataka kukuchanga moto.
As you challenge your neighbor.
Unapochanga moto jirani yako.
Get your foot off the stool.
Na uondoe miguu yako kwa kile kipumziko.
Oh no, don't be afraid of them. Don't be afraid of them.
Usimuogope.
I'm telling you they will realize that you are doing them a lot of good.
Usiwatagudua hili.
Say get your foot off the stool.
Ni kwamba waondoe miguu yako kwa ile chechoo.
Say it for a moment like you are their parent. Get your foot off the
stool. Mwambie kama wewe ni mzazi, mwambie aondoe miguu yake pale.
And now smile to them.
Na pia utabasamu.
Tell them God has a throne waiting for you.
Na Mungu ako na kiti kinakusubiri.
Jesus did not settle for that stool.
Yesu hakuchukua kile kitu alikuwa naahidiwa.
Don't jump on the things that God hasn't given to you because you have waited for too long.
Usipotee ile kitu ambacho Mungu amekuwekea kwa sababu umegojea kwa muda sana.
Finally.
Na mwisho.
Keep the word of the Lord.
weka neno la Bwana.
Already spoken to you.
Abaro limenenewa wewe.
Please, I need you to take note of the words I used.
Hakikisha unanakilia maneno ambayo nayatumia.
Keep before your eyes.
Ni kwamba uweke mbele ya macho yako.
The word of the Lord.
Neno la Bwana.
Already spoken to you.
Abaro lishanenwa kukuhusu.
Jesus,
Yesu,
confronted every temptation.
Alikubana na majaribu yote.
With it has been written.
Na kwamba imenakiliwa.
The reason why God is showing you this tonight.
Sababu Mungu anakuonyesha haya usiku wa leo.
Just like me in time past.
Kama mimi wakati uliopita.
When we go through seasons.
Wakati tunapitia majira.
We begin to run around for a word of God.
Tunaanza kukibia kwa sababu ya neno.
We are looking for a new revelation.
Na tunatafuta ufunuo mpya.
We are looking for a prophetic word.
Na tunatafuta neno la kinabii.
And that is why we fall into the trap of false prophets.
Na ndio maana tunaanguka katika mitego ya nabii za uongo.
That is why we get ourselves into trouble.
Na tunajipata katika shida.
Jesus did not do any other thing other than what has been said.
Yesu hakufanya kitu kingine chochote ila tu ambayo yamesemwa.
Jesus said it has been written.
Yesu akasema imeandikwa.
He said the problem with most believers is this.
Kwamba shida na waumini wengi ni hii.
You don't know what has already been spoken.
Haujui ni nini kishanenwa.
So how can you hold on to what was spoken when you go through seasons?
Je, utajua nini kilionenwa wakati unapitia majira?
Do you know what I've discovered?
Unajua ni ambacho nimegundua?
I discovered.
Nimegundua kwamba
before every season.
Kabla majira yoyote.
Before any season.
Kabla ya majira yoyote.
Is already a prophetic word.
Ni kwamba kuna neno la kinabii tayari.
So when you go through seasons.
Kwa hivyo unapopita katika majira.
Go back to what God had said.
Kwamba ukumbuke ambalo Mungu amesema.
Hold on to what God has said.
Ni kwamba ushikilie ambalo Mungu amenena.
Don't go looking for a rema.
Usiende ukitafuta neno la wakati.
What was said be the rema for that season.
Wacha ambalo ni neno alikuwa neno la wakati.
Because if you do so you protect yourself.
Kwa sababu ukifanya vile unajisitiri.
Peter said.
Petro akasema.
In 2 Peter 1:19.
Petro wa pili 1:19.
He said we have a sure word of prophecy.
Ni kwamba tuna neno la kinabii la hakika.
He said that you will do well to take heed.
Ni kwamba utafanya vyema kusikiza.
He said do well to take heed.
Ni kwamba fanya bora na usikize.
In other words, hold on tight.
Ni kwamba ushikilie kwa kamati.
The best time to hold on tight.
Ni kwamba ushikilie kwa uwezo wako.
What has been already said.
Abacho kishanenwa.
Is when you go through season.
Wakati unapitia majira.
Listen to me.
Nisikize.
When you begin to navigate through season in 2020.
Kati unaanza kupitia majira mwaka huu.
Don't let anybody fool you.
Usiache mtu akupubaze.
I tell you there's a prophet in town.
Akwambia kuna nabii mjini.
And then you leave Sunday service.
Na ile waondoke katika Jumapili
baada. You leave prayer meeting here.
Waondoke katika mkutano wa
mama. And then you go look for a prophet.
Na uende ukampate nabii.
Listen to me when the enemy comes.
Nisikize wakati adui anaja.
Go back to what bishop declared 31st night.
Usiondoke baada bishop alisema.
Tell the devil.
Ambia shetani.
It has been written. The bishop said, this year is my year of restoration and manifestation. It doesn't matter what I lost. It doesn't matter how I came into 2020. I am assured that my prophet through God has spoken concerning me. Satan, it has been written already. I don't need any new word. When the enemy began to challenge.
Wakati shetani anaanza kukutia changamoto.
The disciples in Acts of the Apostles chapter 2.
Mitume katika kitabu cha mitume 2.
And began to say all kinds of things.
Na akaanza kunena maneno ya aina zote.
Peter rose up and said.
Petro akasimama na akasema.
This is what was spoken.
Na hili ndilo lililonenwa.
Peter knew what Joel said concerning that time.
Joel alisema nini wakati ule?
I question you tonight.
Nakuwa nakuuliza swali.
Do you still remember the prophecy you received last year?
Je, unakumbuka unabii uliopata mwaka jana?
They are not outdated.
Kwamba haujapitwa na wakati.
I am currently running a prophecy of 2015 right now.
Ni kwamba sasa naishi katika unabii wa mwaka
2015. I'm still choosing prophecy of 10 years ago.
Ama natumia unabii wa miaka 30 iliyopita.
One day my pastor prophesied to me.
Wakati mmoja mshugaji wangu
akaniambia. He said the Lord will collapse the future as a seed in your heart.
Ni kwamba Mungu atakusanya upeo wako wakati huu.
And he will give you the capacity to produce it in the future.
Na akupe uwezo wa kutengeneza siku zako za usoni.
From that moment,
kuanzia wakati
ule, till as I speak to you right now,
na napo kunenea wakati
an impartation of vision,
ni kwamba kuna kupakwa kwa maono,
was activated in me,
ambao nilipata usisimuko ndani
mwangu. I began to live in the future from that moment,
na nikaanza kuishi kwa siku za usoni,
because the prophecy said,
kwa sababu nabii
alisema, collapse the future into a seed,
ni kwamba ataleta kesho yako yote ikue kama
mbegu,
na niiweke ndani mwako.
Today my friends don't even understand,
usiku leo unaponiona,
constantly living in the future,
kwamba ninaishi katika siku
zijazo, I am still running with prophecy of that time,
ni kwa sababu naenda kwa unabii wa siku zile.
So when the enemy shows up,
kwa hivyo wakati adui anaonekana,
I go back to what has been said,
naenda pale ambapo pameambiwa neno.
I don't have time chasing one prophet from one place to the other,
na baada ya kufuata zile nabii,
because I already have a word,
kwa sababu tayari nina neno.
And so every word spoken over you in this house,
kwa hivyo neno lote ni neno kukuhusu hapa.
Please, I beg you, if you have not started documenting them, start documenting them,
kama hujakuwa ukinakili, anza kunakili,
because when the season of life comes,
kwa sababu wakati majira ya maisha ijapo,
that's what you go back to,
hilo ndilo unafaa kuendea.
I have watched people fall for all kinds of trap,
na nimeona watu kianguka katika mitego yote,
just because they are looking for a new word,
kwa sababu wako kitafuta neno jipya.
There is already a word,
kuna neno tayari.
In fact, before the season was the word,
kabla ya majira yale kulikuwa na neno.
The word was given for the season,
kwa sababu neno litolewa,
the word was given to navigate through the season,
neno litolewa na ili uweze kuondoka katika yale majira.
The Bible says in the book of Isaiah,
Biblia inasema katika Biblia ya Isaya,
the Lord had gone before them,
ni kwamba niyo watangulia.
The Bible said the Israelite tasted north because God was with them,
ni kwamba Waisraeli hawakufumwa kwa sababu nilikuwa na wao,
because God had already gone before them,
kwa sababu Mungu alikuwa amewatangulia.
The wilderness,
kwa hivyo walipopitia nyikani,
there was provision,
ni kwamba kulikuwa na kutwaliwa,
as long as they kept their eyes on God,
na kama iwapo waliweka tumaini zao kwa Mungu,
fix your eyes on the promise you received before,
kwa hivyo ukiweka macho yako kwa ahadi zilizotolewa.
Because you are in a new year doesn't mean the prophecy of last year has expired,
kwa sababu uko katika mwaka mpya haimaanishi unabii wa mwaka jana umekwisha.
When you see the fulfillment,
unapita tu na wakati unaona udhihirisho.
So if you stop believing God, keep believing God,
kwa hivyo uzidi kumwamini Mungu,
because it will come to pass,
kwa sababu itakuja.
If you believe, shout amen.
Kama unaamini sema amen.
And in my conclusion,
na katika hatima yangu,
it is God's plan,
ni katika mipango za
Mungu, that we go from weakness to strength,
kwamba tunatoka katika udhaifu kwa nguvu.
And I'm beginning to prophesy to those who are sick in body now,
naanza kuwatabiria ambao ni wagonjwa.
From this moment be sensitive,
kwamba kuanzia wakati huu kuwa wa hisia.
Finish preaching and I want to prophesy now, I want to make declarations now. So it is God's will, it is God's plan,
ni kwamba ni mpango wa Bwana,
that we go from strength to from pain to strength,
kwamba tuondoke katika nguvu na nguvu zingine,
that we go from shame to fame. So it means somebody is going from weakness to strength here. Can I get somebody on the keyboard real quick, please?
Nipata mtu katika kinanda.
We're rounding up.
Tunamaliza. Tupate mtu kwa kinanda.
You are going from weakness to strength.
Kwamba unatoka katika hali ya.
If Jesus went from wilderness to blessedness,
Mungu alitoka, Yesu alitoka katika nyika.
I decree and declare in the name of Jesus,
natangaza katika jina la Yesu,
that you are going from weakness to strength.
Kwamba unatoka katika hali dhaifu.
You are going from pain to gain.
Na unatoka katika.
You are going from shame to fame.
Na unatoka katika.
You are going from wilderness to blessedness. You are going from lack toward abundance. You are going from a season of tears to a season of rejoicing. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord spoke to me concerning you. From Job chapter 14 verse 7 to 9. For the scripture says, for there is hope for a tree, if it is cut down, that it will sprout again. Somebody say it will sprout again. You may have been cut down. You may have lost your job. You may have lost your business. You may have been down. But I stand in the authority of God's word. You are sprouting again. DC, you are sprouting again. I say you are sprouting again. Your father is sprouting again. That father's business. That's your father's business. That's your mother's business. That the enemy attacker that went down. Sales went down. I decree and declare it is sprouting again. It is booming again. In the name of Jesus. Listen to me.
nisikize.
The Spirit of the Lord just revealed to me now.
Leo Mungu amenifunulia sasa.
There are one or two people here.
Kama kuna watu hapa.
Your business.
Biashara zako.
It's not booming as it used to boom.
Hainawiri kama venye ilikuwa
hapo. It's almost like things have just stayed in a position.
Ni kama mambo yamebakia pale pale.
What you're doing now is literally managing it.
Nikajaba mambo unafanya tu ni kuliangalia tu
ile biashara. The Lord says.
Lakini neno la Bwana
linasema. There is hope.
Na kwamba kuna tumaini.
Why is there hope?
Kwamba kuna tumaini.
See, listen to me.
Nisikize.
It is not only going to sprout.
Ni kwamba hadi tu kuchipuka.
It says it's tender.
Ni kwamba inasema.
It tenders root.
Ni kwamba mizizi yake.
It tender shoot.
Ni kwamba mizizi
yake. Will not cease.
Ni kwamba haitakoma.
He said though its roots may grow old in the earth.
Hata kama mizizi yake
itazeeka. He said its stump may die in the ground.
Ama kwamba itakufa.
The scripture says yet at the scent of water.
Lakini Biblia inasema
it will bring forth branches like plant.
Ni kwamba italeta.
Do you smell the scent of water in this house tonight? I don't know about you, but the presence of the Lord is in this place. There is a sweet smelling aroma here. Oh, it's the scent of my Jesus. It's the scent of my master. Oh, the anointing of God is in this place. Whatever is cut to the ground, whatever the enemy has put his feet on, whatever forces of darkness have declared terminated in your business or in your life, I have come to announce tonight that the scent of water is here. Jesus is in this place. It will bud again. I said it will bud again in the name of Jesus. If you are that person, the Lord said to me that there are people here discouraged tonight, but you are going from discouragement. I don't know what discouraged you, but you are going into a season of encouragement. God said to tell somebody, because of the season, you've been faint-hearted. The Lord tonight is going to touch you. The Lord said, do not give up yet. The Lord said, bitterness of heart because of what man did, because of disappointment in this season. You are bitter in the heart, but tonight the Lord wants to heal you because answer have come. You may have lost man's help, but the help of God is in the house tonight. The Lord said somebody is wounded in the heart. He showed me this woman. Oh, I wept for you. Oh, injustice was done to you. They wounded you deep in the heart. And the Lord showed me that you are still serving. You are still doing diligently in the house. But you are wounded in the heart. Tonight the Lord said, I will stretch out my hands. Not only will I make you whole, but I will turn your mourning into dancing. I will turn your night of weeping into a morning of rejoicing, says the Spirit of the Lord. There's somebody here, the Lord spoke to me about you. You are almost quitting. You are almost giving up. But the Lord sent me to tell you tonight, please don't throw in the towel. Hang on. For the Lord is about to show up big in your life. The Lord told me, said to tell somebody, don't settle for less. Don't settle for less. There's somebody here, the Lord said to tell you that your loss of job is a passage into bigger things. Listen to me, that termination letter, it is not bad news. That termination letter is an appointment letter, says the Spirit of the Lord. Listen to me, the Lord told me to tell a parent here. He says your child's behavioral situation is only a season, and that season is coming to an end in the name of Jesus. There are 5 women in this place. The Lord said you are coming into your promised season of fruitfulness. You are coming into your what? Your promised season
of fruitfulness very quickly, especially those whose business seem to be stagnant. Meet me in front of this place. If anything I've said, if it applies to you, I need you to meet me here very quickly, because I'm going to stand in agreement with you. Brato Soto Brakata, I need the head of worship on the microphone. Pariata Sokote Brahakataya Ingrano Sosupregedeha Jarupa Kikariata Zuza. Please let's make it a straight line and a bit of room to pass so I can bless you. Pariata is Karuata Bakariata Ziza. Listen to me. Pariata Suka Bakariata Zigea Irawata Suka Prekedia Pariate Karua Shakatapa Krete Zuza. Listen to me. Tonight is the last. By the Spirit of the Lord, that everything that has worked against you will remain in your life from this day forward. The favor of God, the hand of God will be in your favor in the name of Jesus. Listen, this is how we're going to do it. We're going to do it very quickly. One, I need an usher or two that will help me just in case that anybody comes under the power of God and they need to respond. It's okay, they respond. Don't resist them. But if you do not slay in the spirit, once my hand touches you and I don't get to prophesy, because of room, you can just go back to your seat. Faith is what gets God to move,
Imani,
not the hand of man. But my hand, I'm only believing, will be extended as a point of contact for the transference of favor, for the transference of divine intervention. And together, let us believe God that something is shifting already in our favor in the name of Jesus. I need somebody to help me with this bowl, please. If you are going to help catch them, you don't need to hold it. I just did it. Okay. Somebody else said, okay. Father, in the name of Jesus. Shali brato saka brata zikata. I decree and declare from wilderness to blessedness. Yes, that's it. Shana Baba. I decree and declare from wilderness to blessedness. Receive your blessing. You can go back to your seat once I pray for you. Father, I decree, go from wilderness to blessedness. In the name of Jesus. The Lord said, it is budding again. Oh yes, it's budding again. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. It is done. In Jesus' name. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Shalababa. Can we worship something for Femi? Yes. Flow with me in the spirit, please. Let's stay this thing up. Shalananananamaya. Brato Shaka Parata Susa is Karota Sizeba. Shabana, listen to me. You have more than you can ever imagine in your life. Oh, yes, the treasures of darkness. Lift that up for me. Why? My God. The treasures of darkness are open to you. See, come, you are one of them. Step out. Listen, you are one of the women. God showed you that you are coming into your promised season of fruitfulness. Says the Spirit of God. Go and be fruitful. Go and be fruitful. In the name of Jesus. Go and be fruitful. Let it burn again. Listen to me. Fresh fire on your altar. Baras katapaya. Bariete supa kariata susa. Jegera. I see fresh fire burning on your altar. Barate sika pakadaya. Shebre. That which the enemy wanted to quench. Listen to me. Fresh fire. Shebaladara. In the name, lift up your hand. And receive.
Revival fire is falling down. It's falling down. Falling
dies again
down.
In his hands. From this moment, nothing dies down in this hand. In the name of Jesus. Shalababa. Oh yes, the tree of your life that was prematurely cut down, tonight I decree by the power of God, it will burn again. It begins to burn now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Go from wilderness to blessedness in the name of Jesus. Everything that has been cut down, receive life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Oh, I anoint you. You go from wilderness to your blessedness in every ramification in the name of Jesus. Father, anoint your son. Take him beyond where the enemy has said he will not go. Listen to me. I see like a broken pot before you. And in that pot was a seed, but the enemy attacked it from it growing. But even right now, as I laid my hand on you, I see literally that the seed now is in the hand of God, and I see this seed begins to produce. And from today, I hear the Lord say that your result will become supernatural, that everything man has done in their ability, you will do in the ability of God, that your result will be miraculous, that everything you have labored to try and do in your effort, from this moment, the power of God will accomplish it in your life, in the name of Jesus. Go from glory to glory. I declare glory. Listen, I hear the Lord say that what you have been through, that when the glory of the Lord, as it begins to manifest from this night, he said you would never remember all that you went through. Listen to me. I'm seeing multiple arrows being shot at you even before now. And you've taken quite some number of heat. But listen to me. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, first of all arms, the Lord is healing tonight. And now I see the hand of the Lord become your shield. And I see you behind the shield becoming everything the Lord has asked you to become. Everything you buried untimely, I stand in this auditorium tonight, right under the authority of God, and I call your Lazarus to come out in the name of Jesus. Everything you buried untimely, they are coming out in the name of Jesus. Barati se kapaya, brush kadada brekiretis. Receive the anointing to go from wilderness, from dryness, to a season of rain. Sporadic blessing upon you and your family. Kaparata kataya, ikarota subarande keti kataya, shakaparekete sekapalakata. I approach every turn, every tear that has hindered your growth, that has hindered your productivity. I uproot them by the hand of God. Now your seed will burn again. I said your seed will burn again, says the Spirit of the Lord. Ah, Kambara Dasusa. Everybody who have pushed you aside, everyone who have neglected you, may the hand of the Lord.
Jesus is lifted high, lifted high, lifted high. The name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you.
it shall burn again. I hear the Lord say, Barata Susa. Yes, restoration has come to you today, says the Spirit of God. All right, Father, we thank you. Go from wilderness to blessedness. Go from wilderness to blessedness. Go from wilderness to blessedness. Step out, my brother. God is separating you. I see the Lord just like the oil through the hands of the prophet Samuel distinguished David from all his brothers. From this day, the Lord said to tell you, you have been in the crowd, but today the Lord is distinguishing you with this oil. Shama mama. Shena mama mama mama. Brata kapalata susasa. Brate kete susususu. You know, even right now, here somebody, your cry secretly has been to the Lord in saying, Lord, nobody hears my voice. Listen to me. I hear the Lord say to tell you. He said, only in due season. He said, I will cause not only men to hear your voice, but I will cause kings to hear your voice, says the Spirit of God. Go from wilderness to blessedness. Stretch out your hand. Father, I thank you. I see these hands sowing seeds in the ground. Whatever you put in the ground, the Lord will cost you a 10 times harvest, says in the name of Jesus. My God, my God, listen to me. Even right now, Bishop, I hear the Lord say that there is an anointing right now that is provoked by the angels of the Lord. It's a thousandfold anointing. Listen to me. Listen, I don't want anybody anymore. I want to say this before I say what I'm about to prophesy. I don't want anybody to put any more seed on this altar. Here is what the Lord said to me. For everyone who put a seed on the altar, I heard Jesus spoke into my ears through his spirit, said to me that a thousandfold harvest rested on this seed in the name of Jesus. Because you obeyed the prompting of the Lord. And I hear the Lord say right now that every seed on this altar, every one of you, expect a thousandfold return, says the Spirit of the Lord, in the name of Jesus. You can go back to your seat. God, receive. Pariata Susa. Go from wilderness to blessedness. Go from wilderness to blessedness. I declare the name of Jesus. You go from wilderness to blessedness. Woman of God, I see God turning things around. In fact, I hear a song in the realm of the spirit. Oh, the Lord is turning things around for me. Choir, I did not ask you to stop. Please do not leave me hanging. Oh, Masse Bragada, Shushu Bragada. Where is that lady? With all due respect, the lady that led worship, not the pastor, the first lady that led the worship, she was in pink. Where are you? Are you still available? Sheraba, God is going to use you tonight. Where's the lady? Is she gone? There was a young lady wearing pink. You led worship. Please tell her to come here now. I need her up on that stage, please. Because these are people's destiny. That is a stage. I need you here, please. Do not let the Lord look for you again like this in the future. Tonight, God has extended mercy and grace to you. This is a prophetic atmosphere. Except you were under duty, it's okay. Please get the microphone. I need us to stay in the spirit. Let's keep this river stirred. Let's keep this river stirred. These are people's destiny. I don't joke with people's destiny. This is not a show. This is not a show. Mabra, listen to me. God, heaven is singing, turn around over you. Listen, things are turning around. They are going to be fast. Turning around for you. Listen to me. It will be like a drill. I'm telling you, it's going to be like when the Lord turned around the captivity inside. God is turning things around for you. Barata Susasa. If there are intercessors here tonight, please pray wherever you are. I sense that God is that in between. That in between. God is taking care of the in between.
These people are about to experience blessedness. If they're intercessors here, let's pray together. Father, shalabaya. Listen to me, I set you aside for ministry. God has marked you today. Every day he will reveal, line upon line, that which is called you to do. But until the entire world know you, you will not stop, says the Spirit of the Lord. Oh, Baka Barata Susa. Go from wilderness to blessedness. Go from wilderness to blessedness. Is there a drummer on that stage? Is there a drummer on that stage? Je bara pakata sakata. Barekete susu. Je perekete sekete. Shaka palagada. Receive, receive, receive. Shela baba baba. Shala bragada da 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 da. Listen to me. If you are sick in body, I just want you to climb the stage and go back to your seat, and you will be healed on the instant. There's such a healing anointing. There's a portal of healing I see in the realm of the spirit that just opened. If you are left with sickness, whether chronic or not, just walk on the stage by permission by bishop. Stay here, go back. Don't cause any drama. Just stand where I stood. Go back to where you are, and you will see the miracle of God in your health. In the name of Jesus, Shaka Palagada, receive in the name of Jesus. Go from wilderness to blessedness. Go from wilderness to blessedness. In the name of Jesus, I command your season of fruitfulness. Everything that has held you back, the chains are broken. Move forward. In the name of Jesus, go from wilderness to blessedness. Go from wilderness to blessedness. In the name of Jesus, go. Shela brekata sakabaya. The Lord is even opening your eyes unto greater works. In the name of Jesus, go from Oshaparate. Go, 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 go. Loose in the name of Jesus. Every chain of stagnancy be broken in the name of Jesus. Shakapaladaya. Shebrakakatata. Receive of the fullness of this anointing and begin to prosper. Lord, wipe your tears. The Lord restore joy. The Lord bring your hope together. Everything broken, restored. I speak shalom over you in the name of Jesus. Shakapanata. Paratasi. Pakatisha. Receive. Receive the anointing to go from wilderness to blessedness. Let's make room. If I pray for you, you can go. Father, go. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Woman of God, I say a special package delivered to you. Receive good news in the next 13 days. I see the Lord visit your family. I see everything that has been stagnated gain acceleration. In the name of Jesus. Listen to me. You have been in the back. Even in life, in your current situation, and you're like, Lord, don't you see me? Just like I stretch my hands to where you are, I literally see the hand of God stretching out to you and bringing you to the place that you have been asking him for. Listen to me, even right now, if you are here tonight, you are believing God to marry her. I hear the Lord say, 6 months blessing. I just began to hear wedding bells. If there's anybody here, receive that blessing. God has sorted it out for you. In the name of Jesus. Shaka parata suza. Inka pariate suze. Go from wilderness to blessedness. Shaka parata ya. Parakatese. Poto sheke fekete. Jariata suza. Parata sekete fekete saka paraya. There is a call on your life. The hand of the Lord is mighty upon you. Walk with the Lord. God has a great plan. God has a great plan. And it is global in dimension. It is global in dimension. Fresh fire on your altar. Fresh fire. You are going higher. You are going higher. You are going to the next level. Jesus, receive. Receive in the name of Jesus. Go from wilderness to blessedness. In the name of Jesus. Listen to me. Everything you have left behind is behind. Now on to greater works, says the Spirit of the Lord. We have fruits. Thousandfold. 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 In the name of Jesus, go from wilderness to blessedness. In the name of Jesus, listen to me. The Lord who has helped me is picking you up now. He's taking you beyond your wildest dream. In the name of Jesus, go in the power of the Spirit. Return to grace. Return to favor. In the name of Jesus, go stronger. Go further. I see acceleration. It's your posture. Every chain is broken. Go straight into the blessedness of God. From tonight, go forward. Go forward. Move. Speed. Go forward. In the name of Jesus, go forward. Give me the anointing. Father, things will be easier from this moment. In the name of Jesus, go forward. Step forward. Step forward. Step forward. One. Step forward again. Step forward again. Listen to me. No more stagnancy. No more stagnancy. Whatever has held you down, whatever you do that has not progressed, tonight in the name of Jesus, the chains are broken. Yes, the chains are broken. Go to your blessedness. Go into your blessedness. In the name of Jesus, go forward. I hear the Lord say, movement right now. Progress in Galaba. It has been like one step forward, two step back over. Everything the enemy took, sevenfold blessing is coming your way in the next 7 months. God is going to show up at your doorstep like never before. Father, I thank you. Go forward in the name of Jesus. Every shackle is broken. Shembrataka. Oh yes, I nullify. I dematerialize every lie that you are nothing. Every lie of the enemy that you are not anything more than this. That you cannot go much. You cannot do much. I nullify. I dematerialize the seed of that negative word in your life right now, and I speak that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. You are blessed and highly favored. You are going places. You are bearing fruits of righteousness. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Oh, mama, shake up, da 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 da. You are who God says you are. You are Mary. You have found favor before God. You are Esther. You have found favor before the King of the land. Says the Spirit of the Lord. Shina mama mama mama. Abrate katumbara tazuzi. Barata sekete bragada ya. Barata sekete tete. Sheke poroto sokoto. Yes yes yes. Every mental chain is broken in your life. Shebrate katumbara tazuzi. I see the Father just holding you in His hands. I'm telling you how blessed are you. I hear the Lord say, it is set time to favor Zion. This is your set time of favor, says the Spirit of the Lord. Shinamakatabaya Barata Sokoto Bregede. Go on to greater works. Go into your blessedness. In the name of Jesus, I see the Lord moving in your family. Everything that has troubled your soul. The Lord said, rejoice, for I, the Lord, have fixed all that concerns you, says the Spirit of the Lord. Go on to blessedness. Go on to blessedness. Go on to blessedness. In the name of Jesus, go on to blessedness. Go on to blessedness. I stand in agreement with you. This is your turnaround. Go on to blessedness. Receive that which you've been praying for. I see you've been praying. And the Lord said to tell you, receive it now as a testimony before Sunday. In the name of Jesus, go on unto blessedness. 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 Let's make room. Let's make room. We're nearly done. Let's make room. Go on to blessedness. In the name of Jesus, go on to blessedness. This is your season of laughter. I see you laughing It's your season of laughter. In the name of Jesus, go on to blessedness. In the name of Jesus, go on to blessedness. Yes, this is your season of testimony. Yes, unimaginable breakthrough. I hear the Lord say in this corner, listen to me. All of you in this place, lift up your hands. Lift up your hand. No, wait. If you were here before they moved you, stay here. Listen to me. Suddenly, as I prayed for that last lady, I saw something fell on those of you who are here. And I heard the Lord say that this, all of you here, you are stepping into a season. Even right now, before I declare it, some of you are feeling fire in your hands. Some of you are feeling fire behind you. There's somebody you're feeling fire in your, on your feet, your both feet. Nothing is wrong. God is just only telling you what I'm about to declare. That there are season of breakthrough. I hear breakthrough. It's like a sudden rain came on this section. And I declare in the name of Jesus, you are come. Yes, I can see it. It's growing stronger. In fact, I'm not going to lay hands in this place. I'm not going to interrupt what God is doing. Listen to me. Listen to me. If you receive that fire, either in your hands, in your backbone, on your feet, on your lower belly, don't let that fall. Please help her. Bariata Susa Kapayate Greke Susa. Don't look around. Bariate Susa. Ye prakate sekete. Listen, if you're feeling that sensation, at the count of three, this is not everybody. Don't fake it. You cannot deceive God. This is not a joke. This is not a carnival. Yes. At the count of three, those of you who are receiving that fire, you will shout fire. And if you are able to make your way back to your seat, you can make your way back to your seat. It's already happening already. One. I need that guy on the drums. I need that guy on the drums. Walk with me. Walk with me. Two. Are you ready? Three. Every side. Woman of God, you are, listen to me, you are chosen by the Lord. Esther seemed like she was nothing. But yet God had chosen her to deliver an entire nation. Today, we stand in agreement with the bishop of this house. We agree with the word of God that the last shall become the first. So today I decree and declare that the mantle of God on my life, to bring national transformation, I place it upon you tonight. As you continue to grow under this anointing in this house, as you begin to continue to grow under the leadership of the bishop of this house, the Lord will raise you like he raised me. And he will place you in the center of the world. And you will become a voice, an apostolic voice. There are people here. Listen to me. Some of you on your feet right now, You're feeling this sensation of fire on your feet. And listen to me. God is showing me that those of you, it has said, I just need one person to attest to this. You're feeling fire, warmth on your feet. On your feet. There's somebody, it's even stronger on your left feet. Who is that person? I just want to release faith from what I'm about to say. If you are here, you are feeling this burning sensation on your feet and somebody on your left leg. In fact, even right now, as I mentioned left leg, somebody, you have arthritis in your left leg. You are the one. Right now, the Lord is healing you of arthritis. Right now, in the name of Jesus, receive your healing. Now, in the name of Jesus. Who is that person? You feel a burning sensation on your feet. Anybody here? Check. Check. We need to stir up faith for the other. It's you, sir. Okay. Barita Susa. Listen. This man is a point of contact to all of you that are still here. God is about to grant you territories.
Mungu ako katika kukupatia mipaka.
Who is that person? There's somebody here.
Kuna mtu hapa.
In fact, I hear you that it's two people. One.
Ni watu wawili.
Aha. Come. Kucha. You are. There's something about land.
Kuna kitu kukuhusu.
Aha. It's you. Aha. Bariata Susa. Don't see. God is moving. It's not a show. Stay in the anointing. She has received what she came for. There's somebody else again.
Kuna mutu
you have
hapa.
Been believing God to own your own property.
Kiamini Mungu
every attempt
yako.
You make,
kitu
somebody around this corner,
mutu
the enemy
hapa.
Frustrates it.
Ni kwamba, dui anakuchanganya.
Please come.
Joe.
Listen to me.
Nisikize sasa.
There is an anointing for territorial takeover in this house tonight. Listen to me. I am standing on anointing that took territory in this location.
Because
the anointing that has taken territories, over
150
territories has been taken by these two
things.
Tonight, the same God that has made it possible for the boy from the backside of the bush, I release that anointing to take territories with your feet. The land the enemy say you will not step your feet in, receive it tonight in the name of Jesus. Listen, I see a few applications for visa that are pending. The Lord tonight has issued an acceptance to everyone. If you have application for visa pending tonight, I hear favor concerning you in the name of Jesus. If you receive it, say amen. Receive that which belongs to you. Now is the time, man of God. Now is the time to own that which belongs to you in the name of Jesus. I see the desires of your heart. Bring your hand. Receive it. You've been saying, Lord, don't pass me by. The Lord heard your cry. Give me the anointing. Barata Susa. Heaven is singing over you tonight. I don't know what you have done, but I just sense there's a sense, there's a love, there's an overwhelming grace that is all over you right now. Barata Susa. Yes. Thank you. That's it. Oh yes. I hear that you've been telling the Lord, use me. Is that true? Come forward. Is that true? The Lord showed me. And I heard you praying. And you said, Lord, would you use me? There's somebody that you always watch that inspires you so much. And every time you watch this person, you say, the Lord, use me like this. Is that true? Tonight the Lord has heard your prayer, because I was about to walk to my seat, but the Lord said one more. God turned back for you tonight, and God wants you to know, my darling, that he will use you even much more than what you have desired in the name of Jesus. Lift up your hands, receive a fresh anointing to be used of God in ways beyond your wildest imagination in the name of Jesus. Father, Shemba Mama Kitapaya. Listen to me. out of your belly shall flow rivers, rivers, rivers of ministries, of ministries. I see institutions spring out of you that will bless your generation, and thus it will be said, just as David served his generation. What's your name, my darling? Esther, you will serve your generation in the name of Jesus. Every one of you here, you've received something. Listen to me. You have received something supernatural that will keep causing breakthroughs and breakthroughs. I saw it like a sudden rain fell on this place. And the Lord said, breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Give me your hands. Everything, everything, everything worthy of praise that the Lord has deposited in me, go with it. Do much more. Serve the Lord. Help humanity. Bariata subarata suza. There's nothing small about you. You are royal lion. He that is in you is greater than he that has ever come against you or any member of your family. You are a deliverer of your lineage because of the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. What a gentle soul. The full measure of your service under this anointing. May you sing a new song. I see the Lord change your shoes to a more comfortable shoes, because the Spirit of the Lord said there's much dancing and rejoicing to do in the course of this year, says the Spirit of the Lord.